Collide Alive on a Wednesday. It's not the last show this week, ladies and gentlemen. We got 5 days a week. And we are excited here. Roxy's trying to get out her tweet.
I'm so behind. I haven't even thought of the clever thing to say yet.
Just give it up. Do it during the break.
It's just a picture now.
Roxy Striar is here. The Marcus, the Yodiest, the Reilliest is here. Hello, Mark Reilly.
Hi.
How are you? Nice to see you. You look happy.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever. All right, good.
I'm fine.
You look very collegiate today. I like it.
Roxy. Collegiate?
Collegiate.
Collegiate, yeah. I dressed up. I'm having a good guest on Reilly Roundtable.
Who you got?
Sari Lennick.
Who?
She's an actress.
Okay, what does she do?
She was in Woody Allen's last movie. She was in the Coen Brothers, A Serious Man. She works a lot.
How'd you find her? Friends?
I went to college with her.
Oh, okay. Yeah. There you go. Pulling in those connections. I like
fight
it.
On.
Pulling in the connections.
And then Brett Sheridan is here again.
Hey!
Why are we so blessed? We're so blessed to have you.
I'd love to bless you people with my presence.
Seems like you're finding your groove again.
I'm doing all right.
You like
I'm
being on the show again?
Yeah. I mean, I'm still, that drive is a nightmare sometimes.
Fun. My God.
Yeah. It's
I can't imagine your drive.
It took me 20 minutes just to get out of my neighborhood today.
Yes.
Because everything converges onto Lincoln. Like all the people taking their kids to school and everything goes onto Lincoln, and it's just.
Do you listen to the podcasts? On any podcast?
No, that's the thing. I don't have the Bluetooth in my car, so I have to just listen to
terrestrial
radio.
Can you plug it into
your phone? No, there's no outlet. I mean, it's an old
headphones. What are you driving? Griswold
headphones. You got to stay alert. Yeah, stay alert. 10 and 2.
Everybody's wearing the headphones.
Well, that's why everybody's crashing.
That is illegal.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
No, I know. I have one in my ear for the other. I've sat next to a cop, one in my ear, and I look over. Hi.
Yeah, he had one, too. He was doing illegal, too.
Yeah, I guess one would be fine.
No, I think it's illegal, whether he got you for it or not, I think.
You're breaking the rules. You're a rebel, a renegade.
Yeah, I'm a rebel.
You are.
I'm a rebel, Dottie. A loner.
One time a cop pulled up next to me and rolled down his window and said, please pull over. And I pulled over and I said, "What?" I had no idea what was going on. And he said, you're improperly wearing your seatbelt. So what do you mean I'm improperly wearing my seatbelt? So I'm really short, and so I can't wear it like over
it
my chest because it goes up there. So I put it under my arm, and that's illegal.
Yeah. Oh, you wouldn't.
Did you get a ticket?
Oh, it was like a $800 ticket.
What the? They actually gave you the ticket?
But I was like, first of all, I thought this was a secondary offense. Like, I thought you couldn't pull somebody over for it. You had to pull them over something else and then catch them for that. And second of all, it's not that I'm not wearing my seatbelt. It's still going, and then the law is it has to go across your chest. I was like, this is across my chest.
Yeah.
It's like it's under your arm.
Were you arguing with him?
No, I went to court and argued it.
Oh, he's just kind of a douchey cop that wanted to give you the ticket.
At the time,
I drove a Mercedes. I was young.
Right.
He was not happy with that.
Right, so he was like, you're getting pinched no matter what.
100%. Yeah, there's nothing I could do. He literally pulled up next to me. We were the only two people on the street.
Yeah.
Hi, ma'am. Pull over the car.
That was it.
How dare you, young go-getter.
Quota. Listen, I have a new toy. I have a new toy.
I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous. I have a new toy. Because you guys know my toy has been the last like 3 or 4 days or even last week.
Yeah, I know.
Cody knows what it is.
Wait, I know.
Is it the goldfish?
Yes.
Goldfish,
That's my toy, and I like that toy, but I have a new toy. And when that toy is pulled, I cannot wait to use it.
Is it from the show?
It's from yesterday's show. You want the cookie? Yes.
Want some cookies?
You want the milk?
I said yes.
You got it? Cody, you did it already?
I just got the cookie one.
Oh, please let me hear that again.
Is the milk there?
Want some cookies? I said yes.
You want the milk?
I said yes.
See, that one's so much funnier.
I said yes.
I like.
I'm in on this one. I'm so in on this one.
It's my favorite. I want a shirt that says, you want cookies? Yes.
You want milk? Yes.
You want
I
said yes. You want the cookies?
I said yes.
You want milk?
I said yes.
I said, do you have your green card? I said yes, of course. I did not have my green card. It was
the silence like in the booth next door was deafening.
It was. What was it like in that booth? It must have been amazing. I love that man.
It was hard to describe because everybody it started to go long and then it was just like.
Right. They didn't know what to do.
Like silent looks.
Yeah. So every time I say, I want to ask you a question.
You want some cookies?
I said yes.
I said yes. Oh, it's so good.
Who would say no to cookies?
Oh,
I don't know. Where did those cookies go, by the way?
I swear to God, the next person then writes some comment about Jedi Council. I'm just going to ask them if they want cookies.
That's so good.
You have quite the arsenal to pull now.
So. Oh, he gave me a gem yesterday.
You got win a goldfish here. Oh. You want some cookies?
Let me ask you a question.
Want some cookies?
I went back and listened to it. It was intense.
It's the best.
It was intense.
I want him in for 3 hours.
it was when he started talking about his character in the army that in the interview,
beginning, like the first 5 minutes,
in the interview, when I was like, "Wow, I didn't know about his life story." And then listening back,
like realizing he was talking about his character.
Yeah, but multiple times throughout the entire interview, he was talking about a character, not himself.
I was fascinated by that man.
Yeah, he was truly fascinating.
Again, half an hour is just not enough. R2-D2 is calling me.
Your phone's on.
People asked me. I got a lot of messages being like, "But did you like him? Did you like him?" And I don't even know how to yes.
Yeah.
But I don't even know how to answer that question because it wasn't even about that. It's just like he was a wild man.
There was no time to really assess whether or not you liked him or disliked him because he was just talking. He was having a conversation about what I liked, how open and honest he was. I like how he just he's been through the shit.
Yeah.
He's not trying to impress anybody.
No.
He's just there saying this is what it is.
I wanted to get more into so many parts of his life with him, but you know, he was talking about how he thinks maybe his daughter might have bipolar disorder, just like
him. I know. I was going to go in there too.
We couldn't.
Nope.
There's nowhere to go into it.
So he's just got a script, though. So he just comes to these and has a script for what he has to say.
I don't know.
Regardless of what
I don't think so.
That was.
Oh no! Did you listen?
No.
No. There's no script.
Yeah.
No. That's you couldn't write anything like that.
He was once
way off script.
No. He came in. What I thought he was going to do when he came in was sometimes people come in, they just want to talk about the movie they're here to promote.
It sounded like that because we asked him a question unrelated and he just
right into the movie. Right into the movie. Okay, so we're just going to talk about the movie the whole time and we'll figure out stories from set. But he just went. He made a right turn and went wherever the hell he wanted to go. And I said it was very similar to Richard Dreyfuss.
Yeah.
Mm.
It's so kind of silly when people do. I understand the thought process of wanting to just talk about the movie, but the way to get butts in seats is to get people to like you and to talk about you in your life, not just about the movie. So it doesn't even really make sense.
It doesn't, but I think more this long form conversation has changed that for a lot of people.
Yeah.
And I think when you come in here for half an hour, 45 minutes, you're not going to talk about your movie for 45 minutes. You're going to talk about it for like 5 or 10, then we're going to talk about other stuff. And I just have one question for you, Roxy Striar. Mm-hmm. And it's,
want some cookies?
That's it.
I said yes.
Good. All right, let's move on because the other things I was going through the comments. And by the way, if you want to watch that that interview, you can watch it on yesterday's episode. So make sure you check that out.
Yeah.
Just keep checking it out, and go over to the Collider Live playlist and watch yesterday's show, or you could listen to it on Apple Podcasts or Spotify. I highly recommend that if you missed the interview with Jean-Claude Van Damme, that you listen to it because it is fantastic.
Change your life.
Saw a lot of comments yesterday. I didn't see them, but I heard about them, to be honest. We are in the minority.
Minority.
Go ahead and vent.
I was shocked because, you know, after the show, wait a couple hours, check the comments. Yeah. Always checking the comments.
Same team list yesterday, you and I.
Same team.
Yeah.
And I was surprised. I've called Mark Ellis out many times on the gum.
Yeah.
On the gum situation, for anybody who missed the show, Mark chews his gum, he puts it in his drink to flavor his drink, and then drinks the drink.
Mm-hmm. It's disgusting.
I think it's disgusting. You finally called him out. It was the first time I ever stepped to him on air. I was so freaking out, but I was like, you know what?
But you're proud of yourself.
I was proud, and I was like, we're right. And when you're right, you're right.
I was proud of you.
Thank you so much. You're welcome. And so you're allowed to be proud. You know.
That was a great reaction.
Yeah. So I went to the comments. And I was waiting for everybody to destroy him.
Right.
We got trashed.
We got trashed.
We got trashed. Right.
People are like, leave him alone. If he wants to flavor his drink with his own saliva, let him do it. We are what?
You are trashed.
Yeah, we got trashed.
We got trashed.
I mean, I'm a huge germaphobe. I mean, like, I'm obsessive to the point of, like, if I drop something on the kitchen floor, like a spoon, I put it in the dishwasher. Like, germs and stuff with me, very crazy. But that's his unit, right? You know, he's not impeding on my area with his germs.
It. Yes. That's
so that's
thing.
Why it didn't bug me.
What if it was in a, not a see-through thing? Because when I see it,
It makes it worse.
Yeah. It makes it so much worse.
So if there's like no notice of it,
I saw the drop.
Keep the drop from the away.
The hands in the mouth into the thing and then touching everything else.
I can't believe how many people in the thing were like, I do that too. Right. It's his right.
That's why everyone's sick.
What are you guys talking about?
But that's why everyone is
sick. It is his right.
It is his right.
I guess it's not his right.
It's my right to wipe my ass right now and shake your hand, but I'm not going to do it.
Difference of opinion. I'm just saying.
That's the other like you just said though, he's taking the gum from his hand and in the
But he was touching things. He started like showing cookies afterwards and like you remember the Girl Scout cookies? He was cookies.
See, now I'm getting grossed out because now if I would touch that box,
that's what I'm saying.
Throws
that's my point. I think people don't think about that. People just think about whether or not it's okay if he puts it in there, but not thinking about the aftermath.
Yeah. I think if we asked him, he would say he doesn't touch it. He opens the lid and spits it in there.
Oh, that's even. Yeah, that takes it to another level.
I completely agree.
I saw him do it. I saw him do the drop.
You watched the drop.
Yeah, but they're all defending it still in the comments.
I don't get it.
You're all animals. You hear me?
Everyone of you. Filthy animals.
You're all animals.
That stone cracker thing you talked about almost made me throw up on you.
Oh,
when you said you chew up the cracker.
But she was five.
I was a little kid.
She was 5 years old.
That's what you do when you're a little kid.
Oh, God.
Yeah, she's five.
But just you describing that was way worse than that gum was.
It's disgusting.
My daughter did something like that the other day. We had the shredded cheese.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Put it on the table, and I look over, and she's eating it like a bird. She sticks her face on it. I go, come on, you animal. What are you doing? Put it on your taco and get out of there.
Yeah, but you do gross shit when you're five.
But anyway,
she's seven.
Whatever. Yeah. She's 21. She's eight.
You are gonna be a wild dad when she is that age.
I'm sticking her in a cabin in the woods.
Have you guys discussed like what age she's allowed to date? When
you're out of your mind? No, I don't even think about that. So that doesn't exist.
I mean, it's like not that far away. Like 13, 14.
Yeah, it's a long time.
She
dropped the fucking subject.
Okay. Good point.
All right. So we have gum we talked about.
Okay, good.
I got a nice box of Triscuits today from Roxy. Yeah. Not the thin ones. But
they
still
didn't have the thin ones. I did know you preferred them, but it was either this or the, I don't know, cheese something ones.
The thin ones? Oh, yeah. The triangle shape?
No, these
shape?
Are the best.
No.
Those are good. Thin Triscuits. I like the thin Triscuits.
I've never seen
these.
They're good. Really? You don't go to,
I like these
go to the supermarket?
No, I just get the I go reach for the thin. Low salt.
No,
and
no,
the,
thin. Thin to where you go.
Oh, I put up a poll yesterday, and people are going nuts
about the
favorite cracker.
Oh.
I'm getting tons.
Did you put chicken and a biscuit on it? Or
no, I put Triscuit, which, by the way, who knew Triscuit didn't have an S at the end of it? I've called them Triscuits my whole life.
Well, because do you want the Triscuits? But it's Triscuit.
Well, they're plural.
But the box is a box of Triscuit.
The cracker is a Triscuit. Yeah.
But like Ritz are Ritz, Wheat Thins are Wheat Thins,
right.
And Triscuit is Triscuit.
It's the brand Triscuit, right.
I think it's chicken and a biscuit.
Mind blowing. So I put up Wheat Thins, Triscuit, Ritz, and Stoned Wheat Thins.
Yeah, and Triscuit wins.
Did Ritz win?
No,
I think
Ritz is crushing
Ritz,
right now.
Yeah, makes
Ritz.
Sense.
People were really pissed at me for not putting up saltines, which like I didn't know people ate those.
In soup, they're great
in
soup.
They are great in soup, but I'm not gonna. It's not a cracker.
This reminds me because this conversation is stupid. So it reminds me. I saw some. I did see a few comments yesterday that made me laugh pretty heavily. They were going through because people really liked the episode yesterday, right?
Yeah.
I did see. So Roxy, I guess I fibbed
when
I said
the comment game.
I did see some comments yesterday, but I saw one of the best exchanges ever when he started talking about when we watched the cat videos.
And
the comment, the thread was incredible. And it was...
You talking about the audio one?
Yes. And it was like, I don't think they realized. I tried to show somebody for the first time Collider Live because I really loved the show. And I showed them the audio, and it was the cat video one. And it was a bad one to show because they said it was boring and you couldn't hear anybody. They were just watching cat videos, right? And then someone else goes, that was the worst episode of all time. And someone goes, oh, I hated that episode. I love Live. What a shit episode. And I was just like, it's like that episode of like Friends. That you just, it was fine.
Yeah.
It's like our cat video, and it's like the infamous episode because I remember Reilly coming in and going, what are we going to talk about? And I was just in a mood. And he's like, well, there's no stories. And I go, we watch cat videos. And he just stood there for a second. He's like, All right.
Especially now that we're moving to 5 days a week, like it's just going to happen like that sometimes. Yeah. And just like go for the ride with us.
Yeah,
just
it wasn't a great episode.
Speaking of cats,
it was hard.
I hate those videos. So yeah, it wasn't but the great episode itself,
it wasn't great.
There's a video today on Twitter that I saw that Roxy would hate. It was a blow-up mattress,
right.
And it was about to be blown up. It was like halfway full. There's a cat on it just chilling. And a guy jumps, and the cat flies and hits, and they put this animation to it where it goes into a portal like Mario and comes.
Oh, that's funny.
Well, it was ridiculous.
There was one I saw.
Well, a lot of people were in the comments after saying that was cat abuse. Yeah. So, you know.
Well, it just depends on how the cat was. Like, there was
cat got up and walked away and shook it up.
Yeah, but just because
you get up and walk away doesn't mean it's not abuse.
Cody, bring up Randy Orton's Instagram.
Bringing up Randy Orton's Instagram.
Thank you, Cody.
You're talking about the cat with the firecracker hammer.
No. Randy Orton. So I'll tell you which one. Yeah, the first one. That's it. The first one. Bring that up. This to me, I don't love this video.
Can we get a video over here? Yeah.
Look. So this is his kid. God. He's got his kid.
Yeah.
And first of all, he's using R. Kelly. So, but the kid's flying.
Oh, God.
Kid's flying in the air. Right. It's a nice. It's and he's protecting his kid. You know, on the pillows. And I get it, but like. You've seen videos like this go wrong. He's a strong dude. He throws people around for a living, so he probably knew exactly where to make her land. But that's dangerous.
That's the dad coming out right there.
It is.
I get it.
Look, Randy Orton is a professional wrestler, and he knows how to hit his moments. Yeah. He's been doing it for a long time, so he's obviously not going to put his daughter in danger. But it's just that kind of shit makes me nervous. Does that make you nervous or not as much?
No, it does make me nervous, and it's also kind of like. I know that the daughter's too young for this, but if you think your dad can do it, who else can throw? Like, you try that. You try jumping. You try falling off things. You're going to get hurt.
But Cody's zooming in on it, and, like, you can tell that he's a professional wrestler. Because look at the way – look at his hands. Like, he – Yeah. He's releasing her perfectly because he's used to taking care of people in the ring and making it, you know, look and choreographing it. Anyway, speaking of all this, I actually saw, and the review on Schmoes is going to go up in a little bit, but I'll talk about it here. I saw fighting with my family last night.
Did you?
Yeah, I don't know if there's an embargo on it. Do you know if there's an embargo?
Did you see it?
I did see it. You should have come.
Wait.
I'm so bitter.
I think reviews are up.
This is like a Creed 2 situation.
This is kind of like
me.
A Creed 2 situation.
I texted,
Riley, you want to hear something funny what happened?
It's not funny.
It's kind of funny. It's funny when you think about it.
I've been wanting to see this movie for so long, and I couldn't figure out, you know, when you just don't have the in with the studio and you don't know how to go and whatever. So I texted Kristian asking if he had gotten an invite yet and I wanted to be his plus one. And he said, you're welcome to be my plus one. It's on Wednesday night.
Okay.
And I said, great. Thank you so much. Unfortunately, I'm not free on Wednesday night. Do you know if they have any other screenings? And he said, I don't think they do.
I didn't say that. I don't think I wrote you back.
Oh, I thought you said I don't think they do.
No.
I show up today and he says, the movie was amazing.
Yeah.
I said, last night was Tuesday.
I said, oh, yeah. Tomorrow is Wednesday is What Women Want.
Yeah.
And then last night was so I got my days mixed up.
Right.
I said, but
you
could have
gone last night? I said, yes.
Yeah. So nobody's like bugging you about that What Women Want?
I'm livid about that one. I have worked tonight and I can't go see it. And I've been dying to see that.
You're not available
tonight? No, I'm not available on Wednesday.
I know.
I was available on Tuesday.
Oh, well, you should have come with me last night. But so there will be some more screenings of it.
Isn't it out this weekend?
It is not. Yeah, it is limited, I think, this weekend. And I think then it comes out in wide release in a couple of weeks. So they're still doing screenings.
Fighting with My Family.
Yeah, listen.
The reviews are out, so you can talk about
it. Oh, all right.
Let me tell you. This is a movie everyone should see. This is not just a movie for wrestling fans.
I heard there were tears.
Shaking your head. You don't want to see it.
It's we well known that we have a reviewer on Collider.com.
I've heard of him.
That I'm... You know, some
did he not like it?
No,
he hates everything.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm remembering correctly, I don't want to call him. But I remember reading the Collider's review, going, I heard good things.
He hates everything.
I thought it was great, and I don't know why you had to, you know, brush Roxy off and take me instead. Is that why you told her it was Wednesday?
What do you mean? I took you last night. I know. I know. I wasn't supposed to tell you that, but it's nice that you brought that up. His son is a fan
you
of Paige.
You went?
His son is a fan of Paige.
I've been, but after that one, I went the other day. I was
Are you
like,
being serious?
Can you
right
take
now?
Me to more? Because I mean, it was like
I didn't want to tell you. Shit. He wrote it up. Paige. Blake likes Paige, so that's why. Yeah. I was going to tell you in the air.
You knew when you texted me that it wasn't actually Wednesday that you were taking Brett.
I don't know if that's what it was, but
I did not take Brett. You were lunatic. It's good though.
That would have been so mean.
No, I didn't take Brett. I went with Ellis. Ellis went. Ellis already had a.
What did he think?
He liked it. He didn't like it as much as I did. I think Snyder liked it a lot too.
But I want the invite for any of those ones at that IMAX. That was good. 7 minutes for me.
True, it was good. So. Yeah. Was it who we thought it was?
Yeah. No, he liked it.
Oh, he did like it.
He liked it, but it was in the title where it didn't seem too positive.
But he dug
but then,
it.
Okay, you know, okay, he said good. There's a lot of wit and charm. Okay. And
is that frustrating for you guys when somebody from the same outlet as you, it's like when people are like, oh, I heard Collider didn't like it, and it's just one person from Collider?
Yeah, that's happens. Where, yeah.
Yeah, it happens. I mean, that's been going on forever. But
it happens.
The movie, listen. I saw when the trailer came out a while ago because they were pumping it pretty hard on WWE Network and WWE in general. The film studio has put out some
stinkers,
shit bombs. Yeah. Let's call it what it is. It's a shit bomb. Really bad movies. So The Rock is producing this one, and then Stephen Merchant directing it. The great cast: Lena Headey, Nick Frost. The girl, Lena Headey. There's so many great performances in this movie, but it's not just for wrestling fans at all. This is just a movie.
Looks like at its heart.
It has a lot of heart.
Yeah.
And what I was worried about, and again, I said this in my review, I have no problem with Ready to Rumble. I think for the movie, what it was back in the day, it's a funny comedy and it works. But I didn't want to see another Ready to Rumble. I wanted to see a movie that actually treated wrestling like what happens, like, you know, how it's training. And they do this, and they show the true story of Paige. There are some light moments, there's some comedy moments, there's some dark moments.
Do you feel like this describes it accurately? A comedy about a family that fights a little differently? You think it was a comedy?
It's a comedy, but I think it's a comedy with heart more than it's just a comedy. I think that just billing it as a comedy is not fair to it because it's got a lot more to that. Because she did, people don't realize, and this is what I was saying, you don't necessarily need to know this going into it, but I think it's important that I think everybody in this room, I know you'll see it, I think everybody who sees this movie should know that, and again, I'm not telling you have to tune into wrestling to understand this, but what Paige did, so NXT is like it's kind of the division Feeder. In WWE. Well, NXT is like Triple H runs it, right? Mm-hmm. And it's where all the talent is kind of grown, gets a platform now on the WWE Network, and there's a lot of stars that are born, and they come out, and they debut in WWE. In 2015 is when it really started to pop, and Paige was the first NXT Women's Champion. She came from a little town in England, and she comes from a family of wrestlers. The thing that was going on with women wrestling at the time was that it was like the Divas Championship, and it was about the good looks, the models turning into wrestlers and that type of thing, and the wrestling wasn't taken as seriously. They tried, but it wasn't taken as seriously. Paige was one of the first women to really kind of change that and lead us into where we are today. You heard me on this show many times say that I think that the women's wrestling right now in WWE is the best, with Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch, Ronda Rousey, Charlotte Flair, and the list goes on and on and on. And Paige was one, like, really kind of started that evolution. So it was fun to watch her story. Give me the girl's name, the lead here, Cody.
She's the same girl that was in that.
Florence Pugh. She was in the King of Scotland movie. Oh. The Robert the Bruce movie.
Outlaw King?
Yes. Yeah. The Outlaw King. Yeah. She was great in that. She's great in this. The Rock has a couple of nice performances. This is a good movie, guys. You should check it out. I was very happy to see it.
That's
great.
I'm so happy I got a chance to go.
I'm going to get you a screening. Remind me when you get out of here. Stephen Merchant is actually in the movie, too. He directed it, and he's in it for a little bit, and he has a nice little turn in that.
Lots of screenings this week.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Dude, I had like four in a row, but I can't
Thursday.
I can't go tomorrow. Are you going?
Yes.
What? To what?
How to Train Your Dragon 4.
Oh.
Well, we need to.
I haven't seen any of them.
Hey guys.
Yes.
Breaking news here. Alex has seen that movie.
How to Train Your Dragon?
Yeah.
What do you got? Did you see was it finished?
Yeah, it's the fan screening, early access screening, and it was one of the best movies I've seen this year.
Well, it's, I mean, this year has only been like two movies.
But I mean,
even including last year, it's just very heartfelt.
Better than the third? I love the third one.
This is the third one.
This is the third one?
The second one.
A second one. Really? Yeah. I thought this is the third.
No.
If I haven't seen any of them, will I get it?
I think. Well,
no.
You gotta watch. See the first two. See the first two.
See the first one. If anything. Toy Story.
But yeah, so I love the second one was the one. That's right. With and it was who plays in the mother? Is it Cate Blanchett?
Cate Blanchett.
Cate Blanchett. And
what's it about?
How to Train Your Dragons.
Mm-hmm. It's like E.T.
How to Train Your Dragon.
Yeah, yeah. But
Vikings against Dragons for years. This is How to Train Your Dragon is one of the best movies.
He's so upset.
Riley loves the movie.
I adore this movie. It is one of the best.
It's one of the best movies ever.
Animated.
It's in my top five.
Two was up there for me.
And I love two, but one, there is a, it's, you know, see, like a classic story.
I like two better than
why
one.
Why can't you go?
Really?
I chose not to go because there's two screenings for it. I have four screenings this week. It was Monday was, what the hell did we see on Monday?
Lego.
Mm-hmm. Then last night, I saw Friday with my family. I don't know if you know that or not.
Yeah.
And then What Women Want is tonight. And then, then How to Train Your Dragon. There's another one. I just don't want to be, I want to go home.
Yeah, what? I can that's understand weird. That. If I do one thing 1 week, I'm four like, God, I've been out so four much.
I want to go home.
Oh, I don't know how you do it. Like now that I went to one with you, and I'm like, there was going to be like a discussion. I'm like, we're not staying for this.
No, we're out. We're out.
I gotta go home and take my bath.
They're not all like that. They're not all like that. But I will say, it is kind of hard sometimes. Like people want to talk to you afterwards a little bit, and beforehand, people are like, oh, you want to meet up and get a drink? It's like. It is a job.
Yeah.
Going is a part of the job.
And I'm not, and I wouldn't change it for the world.
No,
love it.
No, it's awesome.
My thing is, if it was the only screening, then I would go because I want to see the movie. But it's not the only screening. And I'm going to see it. I know you're going to see it. You can rave about it when you see it. But it's at the IMAX, isn't it? At the Universal IMAX, I think.
Yeah. I know it's the Universal, but I can't
when
remember
is Thursday?
The IMAX.
Yeah. Tomorrow,
You're going too.
That's on Wednesday. Tomorrow's Thursday.
Yeah. You're on the list.
How are you doing, Roxy?
I'm not going.
You're on the list.
What are you talking about right now?
Yeah. I'll talk to you after. You're on the list.
Oh.
Do you want to go?
Oh, no. Right.
Want some cookies?
Yeah.
There's a reason why we had to see it tomorrow.
Thank you.
What is happening? And I 100% would have gone had you told me before today.
No, here's the reason.
You know what? And
I'll bring it up.
I thought you were on the email.
I'm going to
a show at the Laugh Factory tomorrow.
You're gonna have to cancel it because here's
no, I can't.
You have to. Here's the reason why. We're interviewing people from the cast. They're coming in. That's why we're on the early screening.
What just happened?
Yeah.
Why did nobody tell me? I have to go to this thing. I committed. I'm like,
what is it? Who's in the showcase?
It's Tehran. Do you know who he is? Tehran's amazing, and it's his birthday show. Bam!
Yeah, forget it.
All right. It's a whole thing.
Oh.
I have to go.
Well, you're going to have to do the interview, my friend. Who, where do you take Brett?
Huh?
Take Brett with you.
Okay. I 100% would have.
Now I'm like being all, what the hell?
Yeah, Roxy's on there. Okay, it's good that we're doing this notes on the
air. Yeah, guys. Right, so the production meeting here. Let's get started.
Let's move on. All right, it's 10:30. It's 10:30.
Right, I'm not on it, right?
No, I'm kidding. I'm playing along.
Let's get into some news because we should do that. And then because we've already been doing a lot of nonsense.
We did all the nonsense. I hate when we stack up too much nonsense. And we gotta go news. I wanna go nonsense.
Yeah. Can we pepper in some nonsense with the news?
There's some news.
What do you got? Good news?
There's some hopeful news for me and for the Superman fans out there.
Uh-oh, what do you got, Billy?
That's me.
Good. So a report came out, and I can't remember who did it, but they were saying that Henry Cavill is demanding script.
Oh, demanding.
Director and to be a producer on Man of Steel 2, right?
That's what he's been asking for.
That's what he's been asking for. This report comes out and
says, hiccup.
Yeah, he's going to do this. And Warner Brothers is like, holy shit. And then Frosty goes, hold on a minute.
Yeah.
And goes and checks and says it's absolutely not true from the sources. But all this smoke, come on, Man of Steel 2 could be happening.
Well,
sounds like
but he just said it's. Well, I guess we don't know if it's true or not.
Yeah, that there's. But it's all leading to negotiations.
Right.
If you're Henry Cavill and you've now seen,
I wouldn't be sitting here. I'll tell you that.
All right.
I thought I saw him yesterday when I was out to dinner. And
he's
like
6'8".
I was flipping out, and I turned to my friend. I was like, oh, my God, oh, my God. And, you know, I'm blind as a bat.
Yeah.
I was like, that's Henry Cavill. That's Henry Cavill. And he turned around and goes,
it was Alex.
That is not Henry. It's just a random guy. It's a random guy. I was literally freaking out. Like, I can't believe Henry Cavill. He was like, it's just not him.
No,
it's not him. I think if you're Henry Cavill, then you're looking at the success of Aquaman.
Yes.
You know that we've got Wonder Woman everybody loves. Shazam, maybe he has, maybe he has not screened it, but probably has faith in the movie. And he's looking towards the future and probably thinking like, holy crap, I'm Superman. This could last a long time if this franchise is going to continue the way it's going. However, I was slightly burned in the past, and I want say in what's going on, and also more money. Which, well, how do you get that? By being a producer.
Yeah. I mean, that's definitely possible. And I think that, look, Superman is I've said it many times, is my favorite.
He's your fave.
He's my favorite. And I like
him. He's my second favorite.
Who do you like, How to Train Your Dragon for? but I think that they haven't cracked it yet. And I think that they still need to bring it back. They will. I love that idea. There were so many different directors circling the Matthew Vaughn thing for a while. And there's all these different people circulating around it. Let's just make it happen.
I know. That's what I was wondering. You know, you read the report that he's like demanding script approval, director approval, producer.
What, and then using the word demanding or the articles
are? The article was. Mm. Is that Henry Cavill is demanding these things and they were referencing Aquaman. And so when Frosty is debunking it, reaches out to their people saying it's categorically untrue.
Yeah.
I just wonder what that means. Negotiations still happening. Yeah, they're still trying to figure it out.
And a lot of times, like, I can't tell you. I've been on the phone with people who said that's not true, and it's been true for certain things.
And
like,
that is
studios
absolutely
will lie to you.
Yes,
they will. And like a lot, if they don't want certain things out, they will. I remember having a conversation. It was a stupid story. It's about what's that movie that Chris Pine did with. Was it the Finest Hours? That was the name of it?
Finest Hours, yeah.
So when we were doing Schmozo.com.
I think I liked that one.
It was fine.
Okay.
It was small. It was a Disney movie. And it was a small movie, not the biggest story, right? But it was we used to get these reports. We used to find out break scoops on Schmozo.com all the time. And we got some big ones. Like when Fuqua was announced to direct Magnificent Seven. We got all that stuff first. So I got this report that Chris Pine was gonna star in this movie, and it had just happened. So they didn't want it out there. I called Disney to double check, and I said, hey, I just want to call him from Schmozo.com. Got this report that, you know, that he signed and he's doing it. It's like, that is untrue. That is not happening. He has not been in talks for this movie. The next day, they announced that he was in it.
Yeah.
And they wanted somebody else to release it. So it happens. So that's not to say that that's what's happening right now.
Right. We don't know. I'm looking at this report as just being a little bit promising for a potential that Henry Cavill will be back and there will be a Man of Steel 2.
That's just why I always – when the fans will always believe – it's funny because the fans will accuse people of being whether they're shills or whatever for companies. But they are the first ones to believe any report that comes out.
Yeah.
Like if you say, hey, I don't think so-and-so are getting along because I know I've heard some stuff. And then there's a report that says, oh, you know, I love it. I love the script. I love everything about it. See? They love each other. You were wrong. It's like, no, they're doing PR, motherfucker. It's like don't just believe everything that you read. It's like maybe sometimes people know shit and it's never getting out. There are things, I'll tell you right now, there are things that I've heard that I can never talk about.
Like what?
Right. I can never talk about it. And there's certain times that people write to me and they go, see, Harloff, you're wrong. I was like, if I told you what I knew, you would be like, I don't believe you. Oh my God, is that true? But you
they
just
probably have a question
just
for you.
Some things you can't, and that's out there all the fucking time. That's out there all the time, and it's just a matter of what the studio is going to say, what they want out there. They control it. They have a lot of money.
I immediately got, because I'm a Superman fan, because I want this, I got tagged on Twitter saying, can you believe this guy, Henry Cavill, demanding these things? What do you think? And I'm like, now you're upset at Henry Cavill for this? Like,
how dare he demand?
Let's calm down, you know. And then I'm looking at this report going, well, actually, I wanted to. And then I went on with my life.
Yeah, it's the problem with the internet. It's the problem with the internet is because it's like people are strong, very strong here. It's like right away, right now, screaming and yelling and doing whatever the fuck they're doing.
It's hard also off what you just said. People were getting mad at Chris Hemsworth and whoever from Star Trek when everything was going on down there.
Or wanted money, you mean?
Hemsworth and Pine.
Right.
When people are like, can you believe the audacity? It's like, these are business people also. can I believe that Henry Cavill wants to be a producer on a movie that kind of, you know, he's had some issues with?
Yeah.
Yes, I can believe that. Yeah. Not only can I believe that, but I'm in support of whatever he thinks he has to do as a businessman.
Yes, and you know why also? Because he has his finger on the pulse. He also is paying attention to what the audience wants. The audience clearly wants Cavill back as Superman, and he's paying attention to that. So he can use that inside of the negotiations because – and they pull – trust me, Warner Brothers polls and they figure out, oh, shit, they really want this dude back.
Okay, it just happened. He went on Instagram 2 days ago. He's like, I'm at the gym working out next to a giant Superman statue of himself. And then this report comes out. There is like, literally, he goes out and does this.
He's in tune with social media. He's in tune with it. And that's Vin Diesel, The Rock, Henry Cavill. These are people who know how to use their social media, and they can use it to negotiate business. And it's a smart way to do it, and it's a clever way to do it. And they've been doing it, and they've been using it. And that's – he will do another Superman movie. It will happen. I don't know
about that. I'm not sure that he will, but I hope so. I'm not even his biggest fan as Superman, but finally we started to get to see the Superman that I wanted to see in him. Like, we just got that little tease. Yeah. So now I'm in.
Right.
You guys finally got me. Took you 3 movies of his, and I'm finally in.
And now we're out. Yeah.
That's the thing. Yeah. You can just go. Just make a Superman movie.
Yep.
Yeah. You don't, like, you can reference things from Man of Steel, but just, you could just drop him right in. We know exactly where he is right now. He saved the world. Justice League happened. Aquaman's underwater saving the world. He can go He's alive.
So there's that.
I
wanted them to tie in that thing when Superman had got shot into the water, and then you hear the whale sound. You know, people always thought that it was Aquaman who was helping him. I wanted them to tie that in there.
I was so hoping they would.
Especially I know that they must have known that because so many people were talking about it. I wonder why they didn't.
It's the Star Wars syndrome. It's the same thing. There's so many times where they're like, oh, they should tie this. They should do that. They should do that. And they'd never do it. It's like every time someone says, do you think this person will be in it? No. At this point, I used to. When you go back and you watch old episodes of Jedi Council, I'm like, it'd be great if Mara Jade showed up. It'd be great if this person. No, not gonna happen.
No,
they don't want to do it. If for some reason they do not want to reward fans that way. I don't know what it is.
There was somebody on Twitter the other day that said George Lucas hated Mara Jade.
I saw that. It was a writer. Well, it was a writer from the
J.W. Rinsler.
Yes, when he was on. Yes. I want to give the props to the podcast.
I know. Shit. Maybe I can find it.
Yeah, that's not true. I saw on a piece of paper that they said that they loved each other.
Well, no, he was on. He was just talking in general, like the extended universe, and he said that George Lucas was not a fan of Mara Jade. Just did not like.
Couldn't stand the character.
But it wasn't. Yeah, but the thing
Resistance broadcasts.
Was that what it was?
Yeah.
But from what I gathered from the interview, though, it was more because of pictures that he saw of the artwork of her.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't imagine he ever read it. Because if you read what help me out. Oh my god, my brain. I can't. I would never be able to compete.
We're here
in the schmodown.
Want
some cookies?
And I need a cookie. I'm saying now because my brain is mush.
That's how I feel.
I can't remember the freaking author for Thrawn.
Timothy Zahn.
Yes, thank you. That's how bad my memory is. Like, I could spout out Timothy Zahn. I'm going senile. But Timothy Zahn, when you read those first 3 books, I mean, they are gorgeous pieces of Star Wars literature, and he and George, I don't think has ever read them. But then when you start getting that artwork of the model, who looks like Mara Jade, he's like, "That's not what Star Wars is."
Yeah, he said it's like a cosmopolitan model and steps off the page and onto like the Star Wars.
Yeah, he didn't like that.
Unrelated to what we were just talking about, but I've been meaning to ask you this for a little bit. When you're announcing Schmodown matches, are you answering the questions in your head?
No, because I have them in front of me.
You don't try to quiz yourself?
Well, sometimes.
You know what I mean?
Like round one. Yeah. Sometimes I will. I'll go through round one and I'll cover up the answer and then I'll try to. More so because when I was competing, there was 2 different documents. There was a document I couldn't see.
Mm-hmm.
And so the one that I could see, I would test myself for sure. And I think there's probably a reason that I did good, you know, because I was constantly quizzing myself all the time. But yeah, I don't do it as much anymore. It's more exciting to watch. Like, as I'm watching people compete, it's like, oh, they're going to get this one. I'm very curious. As I see before I ask it, I ask myself whether or not I think they're going to get it. You know, like that's something to do. Because you got a big match coming up on Friday. McQueenie. That's going to be tough.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
He's looking forward to
it. I'm feeling good.
He's scary,
I mean, McQueenie. I'm going to be sitting at that. McQueenie scares the shit out of me. He just walks in. He has this, like, he's just like, hey.
Yeah.
And you're like, don't kill me, please.
Yeah, yeah. There's something about him. He's
and,
the guy.
But he's the best in the game, one of the best. I've been following him for years, so yeah. I'm excited to sit and actually see if I can take him.
Yeah, well, we're going to see. It's going to happen Friday. And once again, guys, if you want to check out Critically Acclaimed and the Harris Brothers, if you're a Patreon, you have seen it already because it aired on Monday and Tuesday, but it'll air to the public on Thursday, so you can check that out. I did a poll for all the cities. Oh. It's still 2 days left. If you go to my pinned Twitter, 5,000 people voted so far.
How's it doing?
Chicago is in the lead, which, you know, I can already say that we've pretty much locked a theater for Chicago on April 13th. I just haven't been able to release the...
Can I come?
Quite possibly. Mm-hmm. And I'll be able to explain more on that soon. quite possibly. And March 23rd will be the free-for-all. It's going to be in Los Angeles again. Tickets are not on sale yet. Hoping to do it by the end of the week. But 35 competitors. March 23rd and April 13th are the two dates. So LA and Chicago. Then we're looking at a few other cities. And the poll did very well. Over 5,000 people. Mm-hmm. San Diego got some good votes. Houston got some good votes. So
can
we're looking
good. Can you put Boston in a poll one of these days?
We don't like Boston.
No. Okay. I will put them on when I either have JTE play Snyder again or if the Patriots ever reunite. That's when I'll put them in Boston. So okay. Probably never. All right, let's...
Good talk, Russ.
I'm just kidding. I'd actually love to go to Boston. Just won't wear a Yankee hat, I guess. Wear a full uniform. What do you got? Anything else? That's it.
Yeah, for Superman?
Yeah.
That's it.
No, not Superman. There's news. It says news and nonsense. It doesn't say Superman news. Oh, it says, news and slash
that's kind of crazy that news is already plural.
Yeah.
So nothing else. Where'd you go? Did you fall asleep?
No, we were talking about the freaking schmodown, and then you're like, hey, what's next? I'm like, shit, hold on. Let me switch over. Just give me a fucking second.
With Superman? Oh, that's it.
Here's no news that became news that I love. This is what I love about the internet sometimes. I just watch people go. So one of the producers at the TCAs, they're talking, an ABC producer, and somebody asked, they're like, hey, would you ever reboot Lost? And they're like, yeah, that might happen. No plans for it. Headline, ABC plans on rebooting Lost. And it just went everywhere.
Was it JJ that was asked or who?
No, I don't even know the producer.
ABC wants to – go back up to the headline. It says ABC wants to reboot Lost, but they're not currently developing it.
This is a bummer because this is on Slash Film.
Is he playing Lost? Are you playing Lost?
Oh, no. And that's why I like their headline.
The Lost music?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
It's a keynote.
Okay. ABC has dabbled in many reboots. Their Roseanne. By the way, how's the Conners doing? Is it off the air?
No, I think they just got picked up for a second season.
Really?
Did
doing pretty good?
I see
I hear
that?
It's doing good, yeah. Okay. I don't know.
Who's the foil?
I think
Roseanne
saw
was
that.
The foil last year.
It's
foil?
Now John Goodman and Laurie Metcalf.
Wait,
yeah,
did
I know,
get picked
I mean,
up?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Foil? I don't know. Yeah. I think it's... They're the two.
All right, fine. Their Roseanne reboot was successful and became the Conners. Kenya Barris pitched a reboot of Bewitched that is not moving forward just yet, but a Designing Women reboot is still on the table. During her executive remarks to the Television Critics Association, new ABC president Carrie Burke said Lost is a reboot that I'd be interested in seeing. Lost is now trending on Twitter thanks to that. Now, during follow-up questions after her panel, reporters clarified whether Burke was serious in discussions about developing a new Lost series of any kind. We'll just stand the
so bottom. So what would have to happen? They would have to a different cast would have to crash on the island and go through the gold and the water and the – like what? Because with that finale, or are they just going to retcon it? I mean,
I don't know.
I'm sorry. What?
I don't.
Yeah, do you watch?
No, I know, but I'm like, what?
Have you ever? Did you watch?
What are they gonna reboot?
How do they do it?
Yeah. Four, eight, do a 15, different 16, story 20, 42.
Yeah, I don't know. How do you do that?
I mean, Mysterious Island, plane crash, all new cast.
I think they're already doing it. Isn't that Manifest? Oh. Isn't that kind of that sort of thing?
By the way, the Conners is closing in on season two. They haven't absolutely been picked up yet.
Lost is one of the best shows
of all time.
Yeah. Leave it alone.
Yeah.
Leave it
I
alone.
Agree.
Don't bother. Leave it alone.
It didn't age well, though, which is sad because people remember the final seasons and not the first couple. Yeah. And so I think that they don't get the credit that they really deserve based on – it's probably the best pilot that there ever was.
Yeah.
And so I get why they would want to take another crack at it.
Here's why the show is so different, because it still works. When you go back and watch it, it still works – even in this age of streaming, right? It's meant for network television, shot for network television, and the way that it's, edited for network television. And it was ahead of its time. It was absolutely ahead of its time. And if it was today that that show would have been put together, it'd be on Netflix.
And it would be on Netflix, and it wouldn't be 22 episodes a season. It would probably be like 10.
Right. I think they could have done a lot more with it. But I'm glad. I liked where it went. I loved Lost. I watched it every week. And you know, there were certain episodes, like everybody else, that sometimes like,
they had their cat episodes.
That's the problem. They had their cat episodes.
I wonder if Lindelof commented on this.
No. They said it right there. Go back up a little bit, Cody. She says it is literally a little more up, please. It is literally at this point just what I dream about when I go to bed at night, Burke said. I have not spoken to Carlton Cuse or J.J. Abrams or ABC Studios about it. So she's just kind of, now that it's out there, I'm sure they've had conversations about it. Cody, you are a big Lost fan.
Yes, I am.
How do you like this news? Do you think they should reboot it or just leave it alone?
I absolutely hate it, but if they are going to do it, I guess it makes sense because you got Hurley and Ben on the island still, and maybe it's like, you know, Return of the Jedi ends happy, but then 30 years later, shit still happens. So maybe you can do something like that with Lost.
It's a good point. I forgot that Hurley's still on the island, right?
Ben, oh my God, what is that actor's name who's in every? What is his actual name? You guys know exactly.
I know who you're talking about.
Michael Emerson.
Michael Emerson.
Is that right?
Yeah, that is right. He does like so many TV shows. He pops up on every TV show I watch right now, so he's obviously still looking.
Person of Interest he was on for a while, right?
Yeah, and then he was on Arrow last season.
Okay. See, I don't know. I can't tell you. If you ask me to name five shows on network television besides like The Big Bang Theory, I don't watch that either, but like I wouldn't be able to tell you.
Yeah.
You really wouldn't?
I mean, Grey's Anatomy, all the old ones. Like Grey's Anatomy is still on the air.
Yes, it
is. So I would guess that.
The Connors, you got.
The Connors I just got.
Will and Grace is now.
Right, it's amazing.
Will and Grace Murphy Brown, because the things that I know, but I don't know new shows.
I watch so much.
Because you can name it all.
I watch so much. It's so crazy. But I still can't.
But do you like network TV?
Some of them.
What do you like?
I still love Modern Family. I love Good Place. I love Will and Grace.
I hear good things about Good Place.
I love How to Get Away with Murder, Grey's Anatomy. Okay. I really liked Scandal till it was just off.
They took it off the air?
Yeah. All of Shonda's shows I love.
I can't believe how long Grey's Anatomy is. I used to watch that with my ex-wife. That's how long it's been on.
My favorite is about when my mother-in-law comes over. She asks me questions about everything in entertainment, like if they work in entertainment, like I know. So let me ask you a question. Why is Grey's Anatomy still a thing? And I was like,
what's your answer?
I said, I don't know. I go. People like it, I guess.
Because Ellen Pompeo is still attached.
Do you ever just make shit up? Just go with it?
I could. It's pretty. It's
you
should.
Sure.
You should.
Yeah. Sometimes I do that to her. Sometimes.
Well, the word on the street.
What, Brett? Why is Grey's Anatomy still on the air?
Well, I heard. I can't do it.
What happened?
Well, they do this new thing with
Grey's Anatomy.
Because
I don't know why it is. I can't even think of a reason.
Have you heard of GoFundMe? Yeah. They pay you now to watch Grey's Anatomy. It's this new kind of reverse thing where that if you give money, they greenlight the next season, but you get a return on your investment. And that's why it's doing well.
I have too much groceries to buy.
Well, you can only pay $5, and then you get the next season. It's kind of like Patreon.
But I don't want – what's a Patreon?
Well, Patreon is where creators go. So the creator of Grey's Anatomy started
art?
Yes. And
paintings?
Started Patreon. Yeah, they do paintings too. Ellen Pompeo, if you go to the $10 tier.
She an artist?
She's an artist, and she will draw a picture and send it to you and sign it.
That's great.
If you do $10.
Riley, you just put Brett to shame.
Oh, I'm dead.
We're done.
Sorry, keep going.
It's over now.
I've already been talked to about stepping on bits too.
Damn.
It was so good.
I hadn't even gotten to the $50 tier.
Man.
What happens there?
I don't know.
Yeah, my brain shut down.
All right.
It's done. It's
this
over.
Restless leg shit.
Oh, dude. Wait,
that's
I'm
why
so
I'm
upset
just dead today.
Yeah,
My brain is fried. I'm just this.
What is this restless leg thing
it's
you keep
just,
talking about?
You just can't get comfortable. You just are like trying to sleep and rolling around. Yeah. So, I mean, I'm.
There's medication for
I can't improv today. My brain is fried just from being so tired.
I've finally done I have the right mix, and it's taken me. How old am I? Yeah, 38 years.
Wow.
To figure this out because I've had it ever
since. Did you figure it out?
Yeah, it's a combination of some medication that I had to up the dose on, and then some weed.
Weed?
Yeah. Okay. I have to do, it's like I have to double down on it to get it out of there. Yeah. Mm. So.
Yeah, I just took some, I'm taking iron supplements. I'm going that route. Yeah. And, oh. You know,
Does that help with the rest of sex?
It's supposed to be, some of it says that it could be like an iron deficiency.
Oh. Warm bath.
But it's weird because this happened right after I started my crazy, you know, Whole 30 paleo diet thing, you know. So it's like I'm living healthier and I'm eating better and I'm not having sugars and things and I'm having trouble sleeping.
You should be having so much iron then. Do you not eat red meat? Do you not eat broccoli?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You shouldn't have iron.
Is broccoli?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Bo wrap. They eat a lot of broccoli and bo wrap.
Right, listen, anything else going on in Superman news? Oh, Reilly. Reilly.
Yeah, I know.
You did it again.
I know I did.
Oh my God! Got the fingernails. See. Yeah,
it's about time.
Oh, it's like Jesus. Wolverine.
It's time. Not, it's you did it again.
Do you file them down?
It's not that bad. It's pretty bad. I'm doing it tonight.
He's like this.
I got home last night at 10 o'clock.
Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go into a dark alley tonight, and you're gonna protect me and kill everybody in the alley with those claws.
Dude, just get in my limo. I'll drive you.
It is not as bad as last night.
You could kill raccoons with those things.
This is not that bad. This is me last night going, okay.
You gotta get rid of those things.
Yeah. Last night, I went, I was like tired. I literally went to bed at 10 o'clock last night, but I went,
Last time they came to a point, they were pointy. They're not pointy.
It's like Nosferatu. Pointy.
They're not that bad.
They're not great, but they're not that bad.
they're not great.
I agree with that.
Yeah. Somewhere in between.
That's great. Okay. All right. Let's. Nothing else going on with news?
We have the big news. The R-rated Deadpool stuff.
That's at 11.
Yeah, that's at 11.
He's teasing. It's a tease.
I'm a tease, but they're kind of in that. Lauren Shuler Donner did confirm that the Fox movies as we know it at Fox are on hold until everything moves to Disney.
Which makes sense.
It's just a kind of the no shit Sherlock kind of news of the day.
So does that include Simon Kinberg's movie that's coming out?
No. They're going to release Dark Phoenix, and it looks like they're releasing New Mutants, and then that's it. She did mention, you know, it's a bummer about Gambit. We tried really hard to make that happen. It's on hold, including everything else.
Why don't I care about Dark Phoenix anymore at all?
I know.
Because I think that you know that it's going to be a different – it's not going to matter anymore.
Yeah.
Doesn't that suck? Because you're like going in and you want it to be good, and then could rewrite the entire X-Men universe as we know it.
It just doesn't matter anymore.
And it doesn't matter because we know
all those people either are going to be recast or they're going to fit into a new storyline. So that'd be fun. It's like reading a comic book. It's a special issue that you enjoy. It's very similar to Logan, right?
Well,
you
low watch pressure, Logan. High reward, possibly. Yeah. We'll see. Yeah.
What if Dark Phoenix? She opens up some kind of portal, new dimension. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And they walk out at the end of the movie, and there's Avengers Tower in the distance. Thank you, Cody.
Cool.
What if it sucks?
Yeah, which is possible.
Which is probably.
Look, they pushed it back. Everything's getting pushed back. But all right, listen. When we get back from break, we are going to talk about Deadpool. Is it going to still be rated R? It's going to Disney. We got some news on that after the break.
There. No, it's not late to the party. That's actually from Obi-Wan Kenobi. You didn't know that? Well, you should, and now you do. Jedi Council. What is it? It's about Star Wars, obviously. It's Jedi Council. Every week, the latest and greatest in Star Wars movie news, myself and Ken Napsok, that's right, the pit boss himself, we have a guest on, and we talk about everything happening in the world of Star Wars. If it's the movie news, the TV news, canon news, comic books, games, and then we take questions from you guys on Facebook and Twitter. It's a lot of fun. We've been doing it for a couple of years now. I'm still excited talking about it. The fan base is coming together again. I believe it is. I think it is. I hope it is. And we're talking Star Wars, so we'd like you. That's right. All of you. If you're not a fan of Star Wars, come on over and join us every Thursday for Collider Jedi Council here on Collider Video. And we have an Apple Podcast feed or Podcast One, wherever you want to go if you listen to podcasts. And not only do you get Collider Jedi Council every week on Thursday, The Rule of Two with Mark Fernandez and Mark Reilly, that's on every week. I believe it drops on Wednesday. It's on one of these days. It's a good show. You should listen to it. I like it. I listen to it. I haven't listened to it once.
Hey, guys. Ryan Satin here from ProWrestlingSheet.com. And if you're a pro wrestling fan, which I hope you are, even if it's in secret, then you should be checking out Wrestling Sheet Radio Weekly. We've got a bunch of shows in the podcast feed. We've got weekly recaps from myself and John Rocha, which you guys will probably know from the Collider family. That's for Raw. That's for SmackDown. We've also got the weekly roundup of wrestling news. It's a show I host called Wrestling Sheet Radio with Jamie Iovine and Elijah Bates. And we've also got a bunch of other stuff in our YouTube channel, youtube.com/C/Wrestling Sheet. So check it out, subscribe, and I hope you guys dig it.
Hey, everyone, Mark Ellis here. You know, when I'm not trying to clone dinosaurs or drinking in my neighborhood watering hole, I am probably hosting Collider Movie Talk. It's a flagship show here at Collider. I like to say that because I'm the host of it. It's every day, almost. It's 4 days a week, which is still pretty good, above 50%. You can watch it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. 4 p.m. Los Angeles time is when we do it. It's live, so you can participate in the live chat room. Go ahead and give us your thoughts on every story we have coming, because it's all the latest movie news of the day. Who did what at the box office? What horrible Redbox movies Bruce Willis signed on to? The DC, the Marvel, the Star Warses, the Lord of the Rings. Are they making new? I think it's a TV show, and we still might talk about it anyway, because we love movies around here. It's myself and an expert panel of guests, including John Rocha, Perry Nemiroff, Jeff Snyder, and other noted noters of note. You guys are going to love this show, and then we take your live Twitter questions at the end of the show at Collider Video. You can always use the hashtag Collider Movie Talk to get in touch with us, so subscribe right here to Collider Video. Check out Movie Talk, and check out the Collider Movie Talk podcast feed. We have a podcast feed now. You don't have to look at this handsomeness. You can just listen to it, whether you're driving to work, whether you're driving from work, or you don't have a job, but you have a basement and ears. You can listen to Collider Movie Talk's feed. You can get it at Apple Podcasts or on iTunes. You also get Mailbag. That's the show that's hosted by Perry Nemiroff, a lot more professionally than I run this pirate ship. That's our weekend show where she takes your letters. I don't know if you write them or you email them. You have to ask her. Check it out in video form or on our podcast feed.
What's up, Collider fans? If you are a fan of television and you want to watch a guy that looks like me and a guy named Thad Williams talk about TV every single Friday, subscribe to the Collider channel. Collider Podcast is where you can find the video. We have our own iTunes feed, hashtag at Collider TV Talk. You can find on iTunes or wherever you find your podcasts and you listen to them in your ear holes. That's where Collider TV Talk comes at you. We talk about TV news. We talk about shows we love, shows that we don't love. And most importantly, we don't read any books, because TV has nothing to do with reading. We also have a show called Hypothetical Questions with myself and Roxy Striar, and all kinds of reviews here at the Collider Podcast channel and the Collider TV Talk feed. Subscribe, rate, like, tell your friends, tell all your friends to tell their friends. And before you know it, it's a pyramid scheme of television. I'm Josh Macuga. You can see Thad Williams and myself along with Roxy Striar and all the Collider personalities all the time right here on Collider TV Talk. As always, put down the book, pick up the remote.
Hey everyone, I'm Scott Movie Mance, and just to let you know, if you already don't, every Friday here on Collider Video, I host a weekly film review series called Movie Review Talk. The title says it all. Every week I'm joined by two guest critics of my choice, and they're never the same. We review the new films. We pick something that's streaming that you might not know about, but is really great. And we pick a Blu-ray for something that you might have missed in theaters. It is fun. It is infectious. It is the Citizen Kane of movie review shows. And it's only right here on Collider with this guy, Scott Movie Mance, Mr. Movie Release Dates himself. Check it out every Friday at 10 a.m. Pacific, only on Collider Video.
You know, I thought you were playing my theme song, and then I realized we're talking about Deadpool. So,
I thought we were talking about DMX getting out of jail. Isn't he out of jail?
He's out of jail too. Yeah. Josh Macuga has joined us.
Hey, buds.
Hello, Wild Man.
Hey,
how are you?
Great. How are you?
Hey, so I think we've reached a compromise.
Oh yeah, what's
you
that?
And I.
Oh yeah.
I think.
Okay.
Because I know how unhappy you've been with certain sound clips or memes that have been going around. Uh-huh,
uh-huh. Oh, you're gonna love it.
Wait, I got. Yeah! I have
everybody.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
Want some cookies?
Drop the mic. I'm back. Yes.
Yeah. Just one other question.
Want some cookies?
See, now this will work too. Like when a goldfish here, somebody blah 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 blah.
You want some cookies?
Want some cookies?
You want some cookies?
Want some cookies?
I stand up.
Yeah. Can you? Yeah. Can you play the whole clip? That clip.
Want some cookies? I said, yeah.
You want some milk? I said yes. I cannot wait.
I need to address one thing, an apology to Roxy, because somebody screenshotted just me and Ellis fanboying over there, like looking at him with those big smiles, and Roxy was cut out of the shot, and she said on my Instagram, it's like, I wasn't smiling enough for the shot, and I was like, no, somebody else screenshotted it. So.
Listen.
I got to work on my resting.
Listen, Ellis got very mad at me last night. Ellis got mad at me last night.
Pulled a wild move.
Yeah. Which one? The super close-up of just your face and Van Damme's
face.
That one got mad at me.
But then you posted the same picture.
No, I posted all of us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was the same.
Because I felt bad afterwards. I didn't know. Because I was posting a picture.
It's kind of a funny move.
It was bizarre. I wasn't mad about it.
Because normally what I do is we'll take a group picture, and then I take a single shot with the person. Yeah. I posted them. I was like, oh, I didn't get a chance. I didn't get a chance to do the single shot, so I'll just post that one. Yeah. And I posted, not thinking about it. Ellis goes, you cut us out? What a dick.
Yeah. I'm like, he was actually upset.
He's like, what a dick. Why'd you cut us out? I was like, I'll post it again. I usually take that one shot. I do it with everybody else too.
It's pretty funny.
And then I was like, all right, well, I'll just post it. And then there you go.
It's that Kim Kardashian meme, which is like, never forget that Kim Kardashian cut her child out of a picture because she liked the shot of herself.
Cody's pointing to the 2,500 likes for the single shot.
Okay.
And then how many for the...
Well, it was posted later.
1727 for the other one. So.
It was posted later.
All right. Don't brag.
It was just... I wanted to hear more about the thought process behind
why I did it.
That was it.
I always... Normally, we take the group shot, and then I take the single shot, and then I post the single shot, and...
But how did you feel?
Look, I'll be honest. You want some cookies?
Damn it.
I mean, yesterday was one of
And then
of
you
the,
did the same thing.
And then but here's the thing is, I didn't take that screenshot.
Oh, you did the same thing.
So, oh, yeah, because then it was funny because I was Christian did this, and then Macuga did this. I pissed them both off.
I guess this goes back into...
I think I put it on my story.
I think it goes back into the...
It was on my main.
It goes back to the Instagram thing in general, to where I don't care about etiquette, and I don't know etiquette.
You don't know. And it's not so much that you don't care. It's that you don't know.
I think, because I think that I do care, because once he said it, I was like, okay, if they're getting touchy about it, I'll just post Roxy in her ripped jeans right now.
Well, somebody also was like, "Is your knee broken?"
Why? What happened to your knee?
I don't know. I guess he just...
Oh, there it is. There's the picture.
Because it just looks broken.
Let's see.
So
open it up. The first one.
The first one, yeah, that one. So Roxy's clearly out of cut there. Out. Right. But here's the funny part is I didn't screenshot that picture. A fan did on Twitter.
Oh, right.
So I posted on Instagram because I think it's hysterical because it's both Ellis and I, who, by the way, for 4 hours of the car ride on the way home from Arizona, Ken zoned out as Mark and I just talked about Van Damme.
Speaking of which, how
did you not tell us?
Yeah, you told me that. You told us that.
Yeah.
You don't mention that you almost died?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about
what?
That.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
We almost got in a really bad car accident.
I didn't know that.
Inches from death.
Yeah.
Wait. Oh,
Ellis, thanks for listening. Weren't you listening to the show yesterday?
Yes, I was, but I missed that because I was also dealing with.
He wasn't here at that
point. It was told in the first hour.
It was told early.
I think.
It was before our guests were here. Ellis told the story right up top.
It was intense. And for somebody that's been in.
It fucking happens.
Thanks for playing.
For somebody that's been in, like, I've been in five, like, major car accidents and. Three of which
all your fault.
Three of which were my fault for sure. I mean, I've rolled cars. I've been in cars that have rolled.
God. Have you done the DUI?
What's up?
You've been in a DUI?
Yeah.
Wow.
Done the
DUI.
Yeah.
Done the DUI.
Yeah. In Pittsburgh, it was just, biggest regret of my life for sure.
Kid.
What?
Were you a kid?
Yeah.
21. Yeah, just turned 21. Yeah.
I mean, I guess legally not, but that's a kid.
Yeah. I was like, 50 yards away from my house, and I just bowled into a wall in my neighbor's yard.
Oh, nobody was hurt.
Nobody was hurt. Yeah, I mean, thank God.
Yeah.
But we were in the car, and we were almost to Phoenix. We were almost there, and we decided we needed to pull over because Mark, myself, and Ken both pee a lot, apparently. We pulled
80-year-old men.
Yeah, more than John Macuga would be happy with, because the Macugas never pulled over, ever, in a car. Yeah.
Ellis was like, we saw the traffic coming. We were like, we got to do this now. Yeah. We got to do it now.
And this girl was clearly just not paying attention.
Oh, was she? Okay.
She was Instagramming, looking away, and then was about to roll through the light, and then swerved, because the truck almost hit it, and then she was swerving back into us, and then swerved around.
Oh, geez.
And we're like, where? And there was cops down the road. They could have seen the whole thing, and this girl should have been arrested, but she wasn't. And then we roll into a Jamba Juice, and these girls are like, how's your day? And we're like,
he was vented.
Not great.
Yeah, yeah.
We just died.
You ever see The Affair? You watch The Affair?
Yeah.
No, but
what's the first season?
It's a Showtime show, right?
Yes. Yeah. You would love that show.
I hear it's amazing.
It's in the Cape.
You would,
really?
Yeah. You would.
It's down the Cape?
It takes place in the Cape.
Wow, where have I been?
I thought it was upstate New York.
No, I think it's Cape Cod, isn't it?
I don't think so. It's upstate New York.
It's the Hamptons.
Yeah, it's the Hamptons.
Oh, it's the Hamptons.
It's the Hamptons.
Do
sorry.
Not.
Yeah. Sorry.
No. So dude, different.
It's, yeah, it's not. It's not. Because
I said something offensive?
Yeah, you said something offensive. Put it down. Put it down. But the reason I bring that up is the whole story, it's like told through different points of views. Now I feel like I've gotten the affair version of Ellis's story of the car crash yesterday, almost car crash in New York.
And Ellis is interesting about the details that he provides versus the ones that Macuga provides.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's, my favorite was when
Ellis name dropped his sweet ride. He goes, I had to pull the Fusion over.
Well, that's his big joke.
Yeah, he always goes. He loves his Fusion.
It's a nice car.
Yeah, it's true.
I don't think I've ever been in it.
Did you guys talk about the Patriots parade at all yesterday?
No. My siblings were there. They were sending me pictures all day.
Listen.
I know that Tom Brady was like lightsaber fighting at
He was lightsaber fighting with Julian. That's one thing. There was like a street fight after the parade that somebody posted to tag me in. And it was a Philly guy, and he was like, you can't blame Philly for all the fights. I'm like, well, we haven't seen any New England people eating poop, but you have won 6 Super Bowls, so it's not as exciting. But there was a scene yesterday where Rob Gronkowski, who's, you know, notorious, just like, Gronk like beer, throw beer at me, where he's on this float and he's dating some SI swimsuit model and he's just like rubbing her boobs like aggressively on the thing. Can I do mind if I touch you?
No,
me
take
too?
It, yeah.
Okay. He's just going like, yeah. It was a lot.
Really?
Like, even Jesus. Even so, like, okay, it's a celebration.
I feel violated, so what the hell is he
that
doing?
Guy, I mean, like, that's what I mean about that guy. He's displaying the woman he's dating.
That's ridiculous.
It was a little much.
Come on.
That's too, I mean.
Roxy.
Gronk smash.
But I, yeah, Gronk smash.
Gronk smash.
I did watch it a lot.
Gronk Gronk? Yeah.
Gronk. I mean, here's the thing.
It's not for my personal like preference of viewing, but I saw some people being upset about it, being like, this is harassment. Like, if they're on the same page about it,
they're dating, and that's probably how the guy is. But it's still, but you're displaying that in front of thousands of people.
I don't want to watch it, but, really I, but what you're doing is not, like, you shouldn't be harassed for it.
Anyway,
that's their thing.
That's right. What they do.
That's what they do. It's Tuesday.
What is this, a parade or what?
Right.
It was, my dad was trying to take his girlfriend to her checkup, and it took him, he said, 35 minutes to move one block.
Right. Oh.
Yeah.
That was like traffic
this morning. Why I wasn't on the first hour. For some reason, Burbank was just closed.
Yeah.
All of Burbank.
Yeah.
Just shut it down.
The last few days. I think the rain. LA can't hang, and then post-rain, everybody's like, but it's greasier on the ground, and we got
it. I'm loving the weather. I'm loving
it. Me too. The coolness of it.
Listen, so, well, I'll tell you what's wrong with the Deadpool. Deadpool rated R is going to stay in rated R. Now it's with Disney.
You think that's wrong?
I have an answer for you. I have an answer for you. People are wondering, because Disney's bought over, Fox, and now they're getting all these properties. So the question is, what's going to happen to these movies? What's going to happen? Are they going to do it? Well, Bob Iger had a conversation. And ladies and gentlemen, he said, yes, Deadpool will still be rated R.
Yeah.
They'll continue at Disney. Other rated R properties are a possibility. Now, the question is,
which one are you thinking of?
Well, I mean, it just about whatever. It just shows that they can do more of these. But it's I think that they could still do like Fox, right? They could still say Fox Presents. It would be just released. It's not going to be released through the Disney.
Right.
Is that what they said?
That's exactly what they're said. To paraphrase, they're gonna make sure the branding is clear, that it's different,
right?
But that it's gonna be under their banner or distribution model and everything. But they see it works. We're going to continue in that business,
of course.
And there might be room for more of that.
It will be.
So Disney owning Fox, they're keeping Fox.
Yeah,
they're keeping the name.
Or whatever they might name it, right? But the point is that it's going to be a separate kind of division. Like when they owned Miramax at one point, you know, and Miramax had these a lot of rated R films, the Tarantino movies and everything back in the day. So we can expect to see. It'd be stupid to buy all of Fox's library, and we're Disney, so we can't put any rated R movies out. It's like, I get it, not putting it out under the Disney brand.
Yeah,
but you got it.
Not just Deadpool, but they have Alien franchise, Predator franchise, Avatar franchise. They have all these different things that they can go to. And think about when Lucasfilm logo pops up right before a Star Wars movie. Picture a 20th Century Fox logo, and then you're off and running.
Yeah. And it also reminds me, by the way, that this call that they were going to do. They did one yesterday, but there's no Star Wars talk because that's where everyone thought the title was going to come.
Oh my God! Did you see all those fake titles all over Twitter?
No, they're everywhere.
Yeah. You guys didn't see? It was like this one meme, and it was like, I just got off the phone with Bob, and he told me not to tell you guys, but the title is, and then it just had like the Star Wars stars, and then people would write Star Wars and in between Star and Wars their fake title.
I see,
but. I'm talking everywhere. Hundreds of thousands of tweets. Like, I couldn't get through my timeline quick enough. And they were so not
like
funny.
Like goldfish ones?
Worse.
It was trending. Worse. And the title wasn't even announced.
Yeah, it was trending number one or something.
Could Van Damme title a Star Wars movie? And what would he call it?
What would the movie be called?
We should.
Cookies. Want some cookies.
Yeah.
We should have asked him
episode
that.
9, want some cookies.
Star Wars, want some cookies. Episode 9.
Artificial cookies.
My favorite, though, was somebody put in Star Wars, a Star Wars story.
That's funny.
And I went, that's good.
That's good.
I'm all here for that one.
That's good. Anyway, so the title did not come out yesterday. That is fake news.
It felt like fake news the whole time.
Here's your next fake news.
Yeah.
Here's the title.
I've been the one we wanted to do tomorrow was top 5 Easter eggs.
You should
in
do the Star Wars.
The end game thing. Maybe I should do Star Wars titles.
It's trending. Yeah. Hit it. Go for it now. Okay. If you haven't watched fake news, make sure you do that. It's over. Thanks, you can watch it on.
It's awesome.
You can watch it whether it's on Collider the Instagram or Facebook, but it's also on Collider Quick or on YouTube. So go check out Fake News with Josh Macuga. Now the real, not real, the Star Wars call will happen from what I'm hearing is on April 11th, which is right around. Star Wars Celebration, which is, again, makes sense. So you might get the title then, plus the trailer, plus everything.
Well, I bet we'll get the title then, and the trailer will come a couple weeks later.
No. April 11th is...
Oh, that's right. It's that weekend.
It starts in April. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying just give it. Here's the whole package. You get that title.
It's the Star Wars Celebration and that Schmodown weekend. That whole thing.
It's gonna be insane.
Is Masters weekend too?
Oh, is it really?
It's my favorite sports weekend of the year.
It's also Coachella.
Is it Coachella also?
I was like, Coach Hala? I was like, should I know who that person is?
No, Brett.
What? I missed it.
I'm
still here! Sorry.
You got bumped. How'd you get bumped back to the chair?
I don't even have a fucking headset.
He sat there,
He just sat there.
That's my pee up here if I don't get a headset.
You want to come sit next to me?
But what happened to the headset? Do we not have a headset? No? Okay.
I'm tired.
I got to tell you something about Cody, though, that I really like. Cody's really like Captain Kirk now in the back by himself. Well, he's got Alex in there. Alex is like a Scotty. And he's there, but Cody has this new attitude about him now where he's just like, he doesn't want to be here 5 days a week. he doesn't want to be here. And he's there and he does his job. He's a constant professional. He gets it all done. But there's just this sass now. You go back to Cody 2014, he didn't have that shit. And like, maybe he did. He wouldn't talk to Ken and I when at Comic-Con. But now he would do it and be like, yeah, I saw you. I didn't want to talk to you.
About the headphones. Do we have it?
No.
That's it. I don't have a single pair of headphones anyway.
Yeah. I didn't hear that.
He's earned that sass, though.
Of course he has. He's a chiseled vet.
He's the fucking best.
Yeah.
At the end of the Van Damme interview yesterday, when I didn't know what the hell was happening, and I went into Cody, he was like, your face is during the last 5 minutes, right. Which is incredible.
Yeah, Cody, tell us from what you saw, your point of view of how that interview went.
Oh, I was laughing hysterically. Me and Alex were dying. Every time you guys asked him a question, he told a beautiful, beautiful story and then miraculously brought it back to the question. We were amazed every time.
He really did. Like, then he would turn over to Ellis and be like, and that's how I have a sense of humor.
Right.
And I was like,
my favorite. Yeah. When he turned to Ellis and he goes,
you're funny.
What you ask inside of that is three different questions and I'm going to answer all three. Do you want to be the movie star or do you want to be an action? Or do you want to be a movie star or don't be an actor?
Yeah.
I have an answer for both. So let me tell you about the moon. It was great. I love. I mean, I want that guy on for 3 hours.
I'm a globetrotter. I go around the world. I love China. I love Russia. My secretary, her daughter is beautiful, but she's heroin. I'm like, what the fuck?
Okay, so for that story, I re-listened. Still not quite sure. The secretary was using heroin,
and
he felt bad for the daughter, but was a baby.
No.
Robots were using the heroin.
No, it wasn't the robots. True. He said that his secretary has a beautiful daughter.
She got him with the wrong crew.
When I asked him,
but he kept saying daughter.
he was going back. He said, because when I said to him, I said, well, you've been in this dark hole before. Did you have a conversation? And that's when he said, no, you have to remember when the mother, she's with the baby, all she sees is this. She sees the baby. He's talking about, like, remembering, and that's what she sees. So it's hard for him to talk to that.
Do you see? No, I don't think that's what he was saying. Yeah. But I think what he was saying
you
was...
You breaking down this whole thing is even more interesting. Because we're all trying to decipher what we got from the ex. That
I don't think that's what he was saying. I think he was saying...
It's like two different versions of the car crash.
Correct.
Yeah. He wasn't looking at the baby. He was saying she was blank face, like she's on heroin. She's not
listening to him.
No, she's
talking about the mother. Yeah, it was the mother.
I think she was talking about the mother.
He was talking about the mother. Being
the mother
like,
was not using heroin.
No, the daughter was using heroin.
Unclear.
And the mother.
No, it wasn't. Not that one. I'm gonna give him credit on that one.
No, I listened back.
I'm gonna go with Roxy in this one. It was a little unclear. At points.
Right. I just don't want anything said to be unclear because I was fascinated.
Yeah. Oh, it was fascinating. But
I only have one question though. I have one question for you. I need you to answer.
Okay.
You
want some cookies?
I said yes.
Oh, sorry. I said yes.
I said yes.
You want some cookies?
But why? Why is he at the meeting, and why are they offering each other milk and cookies at a Hollywood meeting?
Well, I had tons of follow-up questions, but...
It was like Belgium.
Yeah.
It was in Belgium. I think so. I don't know.
And he throws down the blood sport script, and
What did you ask him that he answered, I've been to India, Dubai, Belgium? Like, what was...
I asked him if he wanted a drink of water.
Yeah. I think he said, how was your day, or something? How are you? And he was like... Great, I've been all around the world. Yeah. I've been to...
And then he just went into the We Die. We Live Today. What was the movie called? We Die Tonight?
We Die Young.
We Die Young.
Yes. And I'm going to watch that movie.
Yeah, I'm really going to watch that movie. Yeah. And I... My brother...
Did he watch?
I texted him immediately, I said, you have to watch this. Yeah. He goes, I'm on the road. First thing I do when I come home is I'm watching this Van Damme interview. So he texted me last night, and it was just, ?
Yep.
And then 5 minutes later, he goes, nice try with the sudden death question.
Yeah. Everything. It's like you threw – what did I just watch? Oh, the Lego movie. There's a scene in the Lego movie where these machines come up and they go to get our main characters.
Yeah.
And Batman shoots this thing at him, and it's you asking the question. And it goes, bing, just falls against the ground. That's exactly what happened.
Cool. Pittsburgh.
Yeah, that happened many times. Like, so did you love being in Pittsburgh?
Yeah.
So I would tell you about this time that I had an adventure with a unicorn.
What did you say that he turned to you and said, no, let me finish. Stop talking.
I don't think that was me. I think that was Ellis.
Oh, it was Ellis?
I only got two words out, and it was, hey, Pittsburgh!
Yeah, no, somebody tried to crack a joke at one point. He goes, no, stop. Let me finish.
It was, I said, don't trust the robots.
Yes.
And he was like, no. You have to trust robots.
I'd be serious.
And then he was upset with me when I said they were going to kill us.
Yes.
But I thought he had said it. But he was not talking about him.
But let's be honest. Of the afternoon, the best question was from Roxy because he was like, why? The five wives.
Yeah.
So what made you come back to this one? And he was like, if I could kick you, I would.
If you guys could have been looking at the chat when you asked that question, there was a ton of, get it, Roxy!
Yeah.
Well,
it was great.
He was like, she's an angel. She's my soulmate. I knew from the second I saw her. And I was like, you had multiple wives in between.
But it wasn't one wife.
I liked his answer.
It was a great answer. You can't just say
He basically, what he said inside of a lot of words, he said,
I'm a man with a penis and I've messed up.
And I was famous. Yeah. I was very famous, and when I went out, I would go out and I'd have a lot of sex, and then I realized I shouldn't have got married. I went through four other wives and said, nah, I like the first one. And I'm going back to and that's what happened. 100. That's exactly what he said.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. I mean, in other words, also, he said, in America, you can't sexually harass women, but in Belgium, by all means.
That's not what he said.
In America, I can't tell women they're beautiful because it's creepy, but in Belgium,
you know,
I can grab
them.
I liked where he was going with that and the way that he was saying it, though, because he didn't really realize that there's certain people though that don't do it the way he's doing. He can go up to him, he's got that accent. He's like, you look very beautiful. There's a wonderful hat. And he takes
cookies.
Yes. Do you want some cookies? And he takes it to the extreme where he's like, oh, I'll get sued. That's the culture right now. Like, there are other people that are going to walk up to him and go, hey, that hat will look great wrapped around my nuts. And it's like, that's the guy that gets in the camp. Yeah, get out of here.
What kind of hat is she wearing?
Yeah. That is what...
It's a little one. It's a little one. I think and he, I make it look like a puppet with a hat on.
He just didn't phrase it. He didn't phrase it beautifully, but like I like that he felt comfortable enough in this room to say that and knew we weren't going to nail him. I wasn't going to ask the next question, which is like, how do you feel the Me Too movement has gone too far? Because that's basically what you said. But it was interesting before the show starts, you could tell. So he was looking at me and he wanted to like warm me up and give me a compliment, but he didn't know what to say.
He said,
you have a beautiful name.
Yeah.
And I was like, thank you. Because you could tell he's like trying to rework this system.
He was a ladies' man.
Yeah.
He was a ladies' man.
How do you compliment somebody without them taking offense? Well, he was probably like, what do I do? What do I say? Yeah. Okay, her name. She can't get too bummed about that. I like your name.
Yeah. It's just, anyway, there's just gold in that interview.
It really is.
It was so good. You want the cookie? Okay.
I want some cookies.
I would love
some cookies. The milk one, too.
He's pulling it. He to Cody's credit, like I said to him this morning, I said, you got to pull.
8 minutes before the show.
Yes. I said, you got to pull. Right. Because I had thought about it. But hey, to be fair.
Where's that sass?
But to be fair, I didn't tell you that you needed it for today.
I know.
And I was like, whenever you can do it. And then he pulled that part of it.
But do you think he has another headset in there?
No, absolutely not. We do not have any.
What happened to all the headsets?
That's what I hear.
Cody, what happened to the headsets?
We have headsets. We don't have enough ports in that room right there.
We used to.
Then I'll look into it.
No, we always only had four.
No, we for sure had
Remember, we had someone sitting back. There were two seats back there.
There were two pairs that were already.
Did Beardo take them with him?
No. Cody just said yes, so he doesn't have to answer this question anymore.
We had some
Sundance stuff and some parts went missing, and then we're still collecting.
How is Beardo? He's making a know?
Yeah, he's a billionaire now. He left this show and he hit it rich.
Yeah. Big time.
All right. Okay. So anyway, Deadpool's going to be rated R with Disney. All right. I do want to.
Fascinating conversation.
Yeah. You didn't respond to my tweet, but did you see what I watched on Monday?
No.
I watched Three Identical Strangers.
Oh, what did you think?
Blew my effing mind.
Right.
Even after he summarized.
I got to apologize for that. I didn't realize that because
people were upset about the spoilers.
People are mad that I spoiled it, but it's like, it's a true story to me.
Yeah, and it happened like on national television. That's, so if you were alive,
that's why
you know?
When it comes to like documentaries and stuff, the stuff that's out there, in fact, it's not really a spoiler. It's what happened.
That's how I feel about biopics, too.
Yeah.
When people were upset about talking about what happens with Freddie Mercury, it's like,
wait, he died?
The ship sunk in Titanic. Just so
why I was going with that. It's like if a true story, it's out there. It's Google.
It just in a similar vein as Sadie. It takes a while for Amanda to buy into a show, and if she doesn't, then I just go off and watch it by myself. Right, and it is what it is.
She locked in pretty quick.
Yeah. Well, it's only 90 minutes, right?
It's like an hour and 47.
But still,
you watched it on CNN. Where did you watch it? CNN?
Amazon.
Is it on Amazon?
Yeah.
Okay, because I got to find it.
No, you got to pay for it.
You got to tell me. I still have the last 5 minutes. You got to tell me afterwards.
$2.99. But, dude, that entire documentary, I paused it a couple times, and we both were like, how is this happening?
Right. Crazy, right?
It was an incredible watch. The fact that that wasn't nominated for an Oscar, and Won't You Be My Neighbor wasn't nominated for an Oscar, is bonkers to me, because I saw every other documentary that was nominated.
Because they thought it was a Marvel movie, because Hydra's
Solo, no.
Free Solo is good.
Yeah,
but it's not. It. It's not Three Identical Strangers. Yeah. Tell you that much.
Well, Hydra's in Three Identical Strangers.
Yes,
that's why.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, good. I'm glad you watch it because more people should watch it for sure.
I
want
to watch.
You should.
It's just so far down on my list. I won't lie.
It should
to
be
you
higher up.
It should be all at the top.
I can't.
Oh.
I still have so.
Replace it with effing Big Brother.
I would never. That is the top. That's so rude.
That's not.
All right,
cool.
That is so rude.
Thank you, Thad.
Hey,
before we're going to move on, I wanted to let people know hashtag Collider Live. Take some phone calls in a little bit for sure. We're going to do that.
That'll be fun.
Can't do it with the headphones. I'll relay it to you.
Yeah.
What's going
they're
on.
Always for me.
Yeah, we'll look to get in those headphones. Cody's working on it. Right, Cody? Working hard on that?
Working really diligently here. Alex is looking. He's not finding anything yet. He's trying
Alex,
hard though.
I bet like Alex two, actually is like...
Two apes fiddling sticks in there. It's like, all right, let's see. What you just like music and the two of us. Or actually, and then when you cut to it, and they're just sitting there.
Yeah.
They're not moving.
Alex has to do the time codes. You can't be looking for headphones.
Oh man, God forbid.
Jesus,
Alex,
God
do you realize how loved you are by the fans because you do the time codes?
Yeah, fight the timestamp army. They're getting they were getting after me when I was gone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Timestamp Army. I like
don't
that.
Don't fuck with the tilde.
No. They really get they get upset about it.
Is
they
it really tilde upset. Or tilde?
Tilde.
Tilde,
what,
see?
What's that?
On his name, Marzonia.
Oh, tilde. I thought it was tilde.
Tisdale.
Tilde.
Yeah. Okay.
T-I-L-D.
Tilde.
Yeah.
When you go fish.
That was the best use of that when I got yelled at for the no time codes. Somebody just put right in there.
What's this second day in a row? No time codes. I don't understand. There's people working. What was it?
When a goldfish here. When a goldfish here.
Somebody was serious. Okay, I'm now being
we
serious.
Have, but now we have.
Want some cookies?
Yeah, yeah.
Both of them. Oh, I would have used it on that one.
Like sweating so much.
It's hot.
Yeah, it's hot in here.
It's hot in here. Yeah,
I can never tell if I'm if something's happening bad inside of me or it's hot.
No, it's hot.
It's getting to that liquor sweats. You know, like that morning after, and it's about 11. You have a coffee and you get those liquor headache, sweats, yeah. Like, oh, yeah. And you're hungover.
What did you do last night?
Nothing. Not me. I'm saying that's what it feels like.
It does.
But the problem is too is right now they're heating Studio A because it gets so cold in there right now, and then that
and we get it
comes over here.
Yeah, right.
Well, it's unseasonably cold in LA.
Yeah,
it's cold. This is ridiculous. Well,
it was funny though too. My daughter, who's not used to this, she's like, "It's cold." She's like, "I can't feel my lips." I go, "Relax." I was like, "It's like we're gonna." Yeah. Chicago is like negative 15 right now.
But the they don't know our pain that we grow up with.
I know.
Like, yeah, you raised your kids here, and that was a choice
this
you
is
made.
Trust me, I know.
LA is just sneaky because you're not expecting it. So when I was walking Cal, it was 32 degrees this morning.
Yeah. Well, you know, I had that conversation.
No.
It was so cold.
It was freezing?
It was like 38. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
It got below 40.
So my wife and I had this conversation last night, too. Like, if I could just run things from, like, North Hollywood, I would go to more. Like,
why can't
why North Hollywood?
What? North Hollywood. About?
She wants to move to Northern California.
Do you mean Northern California?
Northern California.
Yeah, I was
like, not North Hollywood.
I was like, we're pretty
close. We're in North Hollywood. Sorry.
Can we return back?
Sorry. Northern California.
I'm like not making that drive.
Like,
she wants to go to San Fran area?
She wants to
go. That's twice as expensive as here.
No shit. So that's why I said, if I could.
Yeah.
If I could, like, tomorrow, like, I would.
Why wouldn't you move back east? It's pretty much the same thing, right?
No, it's not because it still gets. I mean, it's cold in Northern California.
Yeah, but
it's not back east. It's just one of those things to where I think.
But
like,
why are you picking there? I'm confused. Like, why not San Diego then? Or
San Diego, I love. San Diego's the reason I live here in the first place.
I think it's because San Diego is south. If you wanted to move to Northern California, that's probably.
That's pretty good. That's good.
Wait, but I am curious. Do you think I don't know that?
Oh, I just wanted a difference of opinion. I just wanted to point out.
I do like this little thing that's going on. I got to be honest with you.
But I do like I sit there and I wonder to myself, does he think I'm a moron? Because he either does.
Oh, I thought you were just lining him up for me. So I thought this was a bit. I thought it was a bit. Man. You lob him good. In and I.
It's this thing that you guys have. You've developed this dynamic to where because now you said he was like I say dumb things sometimes, and Brett is there now for you to shine the
take
the Gotham,
pictures at the everything I do.
It's funny.
I literally like I'll be in my car and I'll be like,
pops up
oh,
in the
I
back.
Have a booger. I should probably pick it, and then I'm like, it's Brett around.
It's really funny.
Where is
everywhere.
He?
Yeah, it's funny. So anyway, it's just a different vibe in Northern California.
If you move up there, I'll move to Cambria and I'll be close.
I'm telling you,
because I would do wine country.
I think I'd want to do it if I could just run things from
you would San Fran or Oakland. You doing more hipster?
I would.
My brothers lived in Northern California for a while.
Yeah.
I like it there. I like going to visit the kind of funnies up there. I like visiting my brother. I don't think Northern California is my vibe.
That's fair.
And it's not Christian's.
How do you know that?
Because it's not.
Listen, it's got a nice suburb there, right? Stick me in that suburb in a house. I'm good.
I disagree. I think you would do well up there. Yeah.
Talk about finger on the pulse. If you were not here.
Yeah, I'll come back on the weekends. I'll come back. It's an hour flight.
Yeah, but you've got a family. That's when you
I would take them with me.
Every weekend?
No, not here to the shoot. I mean, we do the shoots, and that's about it.
I don't feel like this is well thought out.
Not yet. We just had a conversation last night. So, you know.
I would take them to the shoots.
Yeah, whatever.
The suburbs of San Francisco. Nice. And they're very nice.
Palo Alto.
That's where my brother lives.
Walnut Creek.
No way. Yeah. Is he loaded? Did I say that out loud?
it's not cheap, man.
But how did I open this conversation? I said if I could.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I said if I could.
I mean, LA's expensive. San Francisco's
You bought a house?
Yeah,
yesterday. Yeah. I'm going to live in the I'm living on the Golden Gate Bridge.
You're quitting? Schmodown's over? You're moving?
Did you see Christian's house? He's living on the Golden Gate Bridge.
We're doing
loud but accessible.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Golden Gate Schmodown. People, that's where I can actually do the trivia events now.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's move on. Okay. We have some hashtags, Reilly. You've been looking at that? No.
No. Yeah, he's got a ton
this
of them.
This is what you do.
I got to tell
what
you.
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm sitting here listening.
Reilly, any more Superman news? Or,
you've been doing the show for weeks.
I will look. Yes, I know.
I'll be honest here, Reilly. We asked you to do one thing.
Yeah, one thing.
And we're not getting
how many shows have we
answer,
done?
Ask 70? Me a question.
We've done like close to like 70 shows already on this
I can
show.
Tell
67.
You.
67, wow.
Show 67.
You got a phone call, Cody?
Yes, we do.
Friday.
Hold on a second.
Will be show 69.
Oh, look at you.
Nice.
All right, hey, you are in Collider Live. Who do we have today?
Hey, what's up, Christian, everybody? It's C-Dub again.
What's up, man? What do you got for us today?
How's he do it?
I don't know. There's a lot of people.
All right, so, Christian, you know, you guys all know I love Collider. I love the Schmodown. If it's all right, I'd like to tell you my adventure that turned into a nightmare on Sunday joining the Patreon. I tell you, man.
What happened?
So you know, Saturday night, I do my reaction to live event, which was awesome, by the way. Congrats to Dan on regaining the belt.
Oh,
so I go down 7-Eleven, I buy a PayPal prepaid card, put $20 on this thing, come back home, go to activate the damn thing, but I got to wait till Sunday morning because customer service is closed. Mm. So I wake up Sunday morning,
my grandma
activate
has the same
the card.
Story. It's crazy.
Then I go on to the Patreon, go to join, put all the card info in, and it tells me insufficient funds. So I call the PayPal place. They tell me my balance is $1,505 because I get charged a $4.95 monthly fee. So then I go back down 7-Eleven. I'm required to put at least $10 on this damn thing. So I go back home. And the shit's still not working. I talked to 6 or 7 different people. Nobody knows what the problem is. So eventually I find out that I got to wait for my personalized PayPal card to come in the mail to move the money from the
that's
PayPal
an excellent question. I would
card.
Say I would use a 9/16.
So Brett has an answer to this question. Yeah. He's been listening.
Yeah, you'd want a 9/16 torque wrench with that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you know, now don't apply too much pressure because sometimes you'll snap that nut. So thanks for calling in. appreciate it. And
wait,
any more?
I do
have one question.
He does have a question.
Guys.
He does have a question for you.
Oh, he does.
I wanted to tell you the nightmare. You know. I wanted to join the Patreon. That shit sucked on Sunday.
No.
Thank you. My question is, what are your guys' thoughts? I don't know if you've heard the rumor that Robert Pattinson is possibly being looked at for Batman.
I did hear that.
I did hear that.
Thank you for the call, C-Dub. All right, so
great imagery that went along with that rumor.
It was.
How far was the 7-Eleven, do you think? How far was getting to the 7-Eleven? This is honest. Like,
I don't know. Maybe he works there. I have no
quarter
idea.
Quarter mile.
Okay.
But I appreciate him going out there and try. He's been trying hard to join, and he's a big supporter.
Huge fan.
What is a PayPal card?
I think you put money on a card to use for PayPal.
But why don't you just do it on?
How did you figure that out?
I'm just answering honestly.
Jesus, are you some sort of wizard?
It's a solid point.
Remember that one day your daughter will grow up and she will be a broadcaster and she'll be sitting here with an older man who treats her poorly. Just remember.
Yeah. The way you're treating her is garbage.
It
is.
Garbage.
I'm sorry. You it's a wrestling situation.
I get very angry when I'm in this corner.
Oh, dude, that was.
Don't put that Brett whole in the
corner. Oh, that exchange was beautiful. What was the question? Okay.
Robert Pattinson.
I got to tell you, this came out.
Robert Pattinson?
So when I thought I saw Henry Cavill at Soho yesterday, it was not him. Robert Pattinson actually
you
was
actually
there.
Did see him
he
there.
Actually
listen,
was there.
Oh, so he's Batman.
Yeah.
And it was confirmed that he was sitting with Matt Reeves there. That's not true.
That's not
true. He was not sitting with Matt Reeves, but he was there.
You
that
just about broke the internet.
That would have been amazing. I think that this is actually brilliant.
I think it is as well.
I couldn't believe that I thought that, but
I didn't even think about it. Yeah. And here's the thing.
He's British. I don't want my
Did you see him this year?
Christian Bale?
It's my Batman is and will always be Michael Keaton. No.
Did you see him in Damsel? It was one of those indies this year.
I've seen him in a lot of
bit dick, but
no, but he's great. He is a fantastic, underrated actor.
Yes. He's so good.
He is
good
great. Times. He was good time.
Good time.
That's what I was trying to remember. This guy, because that gets me excited.
Dude, this guy is, and he did another one a few years back with Guy Pearce.
And
right?
He's brooding, and he's chiseled.
What, sorry, Cody?
The Rover.
Yeah. And you saw that, right?
Yeah, it's fantastic.
He's fantastic in that
God,
movie.
God, he is so good, and I
totally forgot
perfect.
What Robert Pattinson looked like. Now I'm looking at him like, he may be
listen, man.
Batman.
Look. So, and he's younger. He's what Matt Reeves is looking for. And I saw Bibiani respond to some guy's Twitter on it, and they were posting these pictures of Pattinson as Batman. And I went, that's a brilliant choice.
Yeah. It's so good.
It's a brilliant
I'm
choice.
I'm so about it, and I was shocked. He hasn't come up. I've been hosting DC Movie News for 4 years, and all of the 400 conversations we've had about who should play Batman, he has never one time came up.
I'll tell you what, though. And I saw a lot of the responses, too. Like, people are on board with this, and it just shows how good of an actor he is because when he came out of that Twilight series, everyone's like, the Twilight kid, get him out of here. But he has done so much to repair that, to shed that image of just being the Twilight kid. He's a fantastic actor.
He's so good. If anybody
he's
thinks
Cedric
that, Diggory. Still,
you
still,
yeah,
yes. Right.
He sure is. Yeah.
But if anybody thinks that, you know, the Twilight kid, please go watch Good Time.
Yeah.
That I can't recommend it enough for getting that vision out of there and realizing this guy is a powerhouse.
He's great. And he does a New York accent in that one, too.
There it is.
Okay, great question. Great question. And I think the question then is Robert Pattinson a good choice for Batman?
I hope I didn't offend all of England when I said I don't want my Batman to be British, but
you probably did.
You already have
did.
Your Bond as a Brit, you know, leave some for the Americans.
Yeah.
Very funny. All right. So let's.
Christian did not like that one.
Which one?
I don't know. Very funny. Done.
No. I was thinking about the exchange you guys had. and it was brilliant. It was good. I like this thing that's going on, the jabbing back and forth. I enjoy it very much.
I have a Twitter question for you, Christian.
Oh, thank God you're doing your job. I like it.
Yeah. All right. You can go fuck yourself.
All right. Yeah. Why'd you steal Brett's seat if you're just going to sit there looking at your hair and your reflection?
Can I do that?
It does look really
good. Did you see the kitchen knives on his hands again?
Yeah. Oh, my God. It's just embarrassing.
As I said, they're not that bad.
They're bad.
Right. No. They're bad. They're not that bad.
As a man, your fingernails should never be longer. Yeah.
But you saw them last time.
Yeah. Last time they were awful.
They were awful.
These
are still not good.
By comparison.
Yeah.
These are still not good.
He looks like, you know when girls get those sharp nail things done now? Mm-hmm. They like look real sharp like claws.
Yeah, bring up Nosferatu. Yeah. Bring up a picture of Nosferatu.
Did you listen to the first half of the show where I talked about what happened with the waitress? Or no?
No, I missed that whole thing.
You missed it?
You can tell me at lunch today and hopefully I don't get poisoned.
Here you go, right there. There's a zoom in on his fingernails.
There you go.
Look at that.
It looks nothing like that, Christian.
It
looks nothing like that.
Put your hand next to Nosferatu's hands.
No.
Just hold it up in the air. There you go. Look, it's the same claw. Look at that.
But I can do that.
Do you remember the one?
Could cut onions with those things.
Do you remember the one Family Guy? It was way back when they all stepped in a pile of ooze and like Peter became it. And Meg just had nails that grew fast.
Yeah. That's it.
Ow!
I love it. Cody keeps zooming in on the picture a little bit more. Okay. Let's get a tweet.
This is funny, and I know this would be a new toy for you.
Okay.
At Matt Peters 85, please mix the Van Damme cookie quote with the Schwarzenegger put the cookies down quote.
Oh yes. Well, I'm sure that somebody's already done that.
Sure, it
yeah,
will happen.
Listen, I need to make a shirt that says, do you want a cookie?
Yeah.
Do you want some cookies? Yes.
Yeah.
Do you want some milk? Yes.
Bloodsport.
Boom. It was, he followed it up with the green card thing.
Yeah.
And then he said, you have your green card? I said, of course I do. I did not.
I did not.
That was good.
You ever seen Bloodsport?
No.
Oh, you'd like it. It's a classic.
It's good. Yeah. It's the best. Okay. Yeah.
What?
There's a part in the movie. You'd know it if you saw it. All right, let's move on to. You got any more phone calls, Cody? Home?
Yeah, we do.
All right. Hey, you're in Collider Live. Who do we got?
Hey, it's Robert from Oklahoma.
Hello, Robert from Oklahoma. How are you doing?
Well. I'm doing well. You know, my PayPal card worked, so I don't know what what that other guy's problem was.
I think he didn't put enough money on the card. I think that was the problem. I think he didn't put enough money on the card.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. Anyway,
what are you gonna do?
I just
So I was watching the Super Bowl on Sunday, just like everybody else, unfortunately, and I was really confused why CBS decided to show that new America's Got Talent ripoff show, and like, in my opinion, wouldn't it have been smarter to maybe try to push their streaming service that nobody seems to buy? Oof. Maybe show an episode of Star Trek, or maybe show the first episode of their new Twilight Zone reboot. Mm-hmm. Would that have been maybe a little business smarter for their streaming service?
I wouldn't say so much as a hobby, but I think spelunking is my passion. So
yeah. So what about a follow-up to that?
Yeah, if any follow-up question? Or?
He did. He asked.
Oh, good. Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah. Yes, I do love it.
Okay, good. Stop. Okay.
I'm glad I tuned in to Tool Talk.
Thank you very much.
That works on two levels.
Look, Robert from Oklahoma makes a solid point.
Thanks for the call.
So great point.
That is, listen, I think he's 100% right.
Yeah.
I think
it was such a wasted opportunity.
What a stupid show. Did that show even do good? No.
I have no idea.
How
I haven't heard about
how
it.
How long will it stick around? It is an absolute ripoff. He couldn't be more right.
Yeah.
Nobody knows what's on CBS All Access. Except us.
No. People in this industry know it exists.
That's it.
No one else knows that it's a streaming service.
What's CBS All Access? Right. Is that on my... Is that after 9 p.m.? Let me press it next to my CBS. Do I have the access button? No, because it's on the internet and nobody's watching anything on there except for Thad and Jason.
Well, he said that right. They should have gotten a big guest star, like a huge guest star for Star Trek, right? And aired an episode of that thing right after the Super Bowl.
I think Twilight. I think you go Twilight. Because remember, I didn't
Twilight Zone.
Oh, Twilight Zone.
I didn't even know that it was...
It's not ready yet.
On CBS All Access.
Yeah, I thought it was on Netflix.
Yeah. Or like here's 5 minutes.
Like the best episode. Put the best episode up and then say, you want more of this, go check us out now. Yeah,
they really need...
He was right. That kid was right.
They need the eyes on it. I mean, I'm bummed, but I'm still going to watch it. The Stand is going to CBS All Access.
Yeah.
The Stephen King adaptation. Yes. I thought it was going to be a movie. I wanted CBS the movie. All Access? It's going to go CBS All Access. So they need to start. They're pumping in. They're putting some big projects
on there.
How much
is it?
There's a good and bad to that, obviously.
Yeah.
The good to this is the fact that there's going to be shows that are not doing well on network television, right, that now have a chance to succeed, and the numbers don't have to be that big on this streaming service in order to survive. Now, the question is, how long will the streaming service survive? But you, at least you can put these type of shows on there. Now, the bad news, obviously, is if you... Like, the CBS streaming service is nothing I'm interested in. I have I have no interest in subscribing to that service.
Same. So The Stand is going to be really test my fandom with Stephen King in this book and this adaptation and Josh Boone doing it.
Yeah.
You say Netflix, Hulu, oh, my God, HBO. I was hoping HBO, but... It's CBS All Access.
It doesn't
access.
Say right here on the app the price right away. It's like try free.
Right.
And that's how they get you.
And they charge your card afterwards,
like $4.99, $7.99, or $10.99. Like, it's a choose.
Whatever it is, though. It's like it's. But I say I have no interest in it, but what if I'm watching the Super Bowl, and at the end...
There's a Twilight Zone episode.
It pops out,
like,
I'll check it out,
God.
And it kicks my ass. I'm like, whoa!
Right.
I'm going to go and check this out. The other thing is, I do want to address one thing, though, too, because people have been tweeting me at it, too. And you know probably better than I do. Who's Trey? What's his face from ESPN that went...
Trey Wingo.
What an idiot.
Yeah.
He goes off and screaming at people. He's like, if you don't like the game, then why are you watching? You're glued to it, going, oh, but I'm watching it. You're glued to it. I was never glued to that game.
No.
I was watching it because I wanted to see what was going to happen. I was bored out of my skull.
Correct.
Not one time was I like, oh, my God, I can't stop watching this game. I wanted it to end. Yeah. I wanted something to happen, and it never happened. This guy's yelling at people. He's like turning into Bill Maher.
Yeah.
And he's like,
it was embarrassing.
Shut up. It was so embarrassing. It was the wrong rant to have,
It was very embarrassing. It wasn't – the rant to have on that one is not like people are bored by the Super Bowl. The rant to have on that one is to – like, where was the entertainment value, or like what was the halftime show, or yada, yada, yada. The rant wasn't – like, the rant should have been both offenses didn't show up. It wasn't, people are bored by the Super Bowl, because it was a boring effing game.
It was a boring game.
Boring.
And that was the thing. It wasn't a matter of, like,
unless you're a Patriots fan.
Then why are you watching it? Because we're fans. That's what everybody's doing. There's parties. Yes. We're going to shut it off in the middle of it. So we're going to try to watch it and say, ugh. It's like watching a movie. You watch the movie to the end, you go, that movie stunk.
Perfect comparison is, I watched all of Roma because I thought something had to happen.
Yeah.
Something had to happen.
It didn't.
And you didn't like it.
And I didn't.
And it's your right to say it's boring.
There you go.
I could scream at you. It's like, well, you were glued to it. You weren't glued to it. You didn't like it.
Yeah.
You're bored out of your skull.
It was very disappointing for me because this was the first time my son's watching. Like, I actually sat down and watched an entire game because it's like it's a thing my wife and I are doing with my son, and I'm like, yeah, that sucked. That was
that's 4 hours.
I'm trying
to get
excited here.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just it was embarrassing when I was watching. And the other thing is, and Bill Maher too. We went all in on being a moron.
Yeah, he's
he went all in on being a moron.
That's his thing now, isn't it?
I mean, he's an idiot. He's a pure idiot.
It's like, legitimately his thing. Like that is what he's known for at this point, which is so crazy.
He went after. I mean,
he's supposed to be the intelligent guy.
Yeah. He's an idiot. He's an absolute imbecile. Like when you went into there was that whole conversation that about Stan Lee, and then he offended everybody. He loved that he offended everybody, and then he went all in on it, and he's like, no, I was talking about you. If you like, then you are living in your childhood, and you are a moron. On. And he laughed there with his people on the desk, like, oh, we're so funny, we're making fun of people.
And then uses a Vibranium joke a week later, sets it up with Captain America.
He's not a good dude. He is a buffoon. He's not a good dude. He's a douche.
Anytime any of my conservative friends give me crap, like, oh, you give every single liberal pass, you love all liberals, I'm just like, Bill Maher
is a horrible Bill human Maher. Being. Yeah, he's just not a good dude. Yeah. Anyway, so moving on there, do we have got another tweet?
I got one because you guys at the beginning of the show were like, we're so alone on this. James C., I had to skip the chewing gum discussion. Mark Ellis made my stomach turn. I'm completely with you, Roxy and Christian.
Thank you.
Just wrong.
It's so gross.
Now, where do you stand on this? Honest opinion. We're sitting here. You've seen him do it a million times, but we talked about it on the air yesterday. Right before we started the show, Ellis had his, it was like water or whatever the hell it was yesterday.
Ice water.
It was iced tea that turned into water, and he filled it up. But right before we start, he takes the gum out of his mouth, plops it in the drink, and continues to drink it out.
No,
it's like an ice cube. But the fans were defending
him. You've seen him do it before, right?
Yeah.
The fans were defending
him. I mean, it's not the most disgusting thing you'll ever see anybody do. It's just like putting mint in something, but it's also like...
You were a kid? He's sticking his fingers in his mouth and he started touching the cookies.
You finish that sentence. You were a kid and what? Something with crackers?
No. Remember when you were a kid and you'd go to like a sports banquet or like a wedding or something. You'd be bored at the table and you take the salt pepper shaker and you put it in your drink. And you take a little bit of hot dust and you put a little ketchup, a little bit of the napkin. Like, that's what Mark is getting to. But also when we got in his car, and we always make fun of him for making him, but he did clean out his car except for one thing. In the center dash, there was a ton of balled up gum in the paper. Just like gum. And so we got to the gas station. I just started putting it into a trash thing, and he was like, "Thanks for cleaning up that gum." I was like, "Yeah, sure, no problem."
Right.
I just couldn't sit here in this car and look at gum piles. And it's that's disgusting. That.
All right. Yeah. So thank you for being with us on that. Let's do. What time is it?
But he's chewing gum and he's appreciative of the people around him to not have bad breath, and I think that's important, especially when you're talking.
Didn't like that he stuck his hands in his mouth and he started touching the cookies.
Are together.
Yeah. All right. What's next? Do we have a phone call?
Yeah, we do. All right. We really do.
Thank you, Cody.
Come on,
hey,
ladies.
What's up, guys?
Hey, you're in Collider. Who's this?
Hey, what?
This is C-Dub again.
No, it isn't.
I'm just kidding.
What's up? Who do we got?
So this is Luke.
What's up,
from
Luke?
From New York in the Bronx now. Josh Macuga.
What up?
I was actually the guy at the show that had the Night Terrors, too.
Nice.
A high five.
Yes.
Front row. So, yeah, that was a good time.
Welcome to the Thunderdome, my friend. Yeah. Thanks for coming, man. Dude. Thanks for coming.
And my girlfriend, she is also just like super, she's a super fucking, heavy sleeper. So when I wake up screaming, she just kind of turns at me and she's just like, man, God damn it, shut the fuck up. And I am losing, my fucking mind. And she has no sympathy. She's just like, shut the fuck up, man.
I like her.
Go back to sleep.
Yeah, you would do
that. She doesn't get it.
Brad,
In this order, Golden Girls, A Small Wonder, and Saved by the Bell.
Thank you, Brad. So did that answer your question?
That does, yeah.
Okay, good.
I have a question.
What's up?
If you want it.
Sure,
if Brad wants it.
Okay.
Since you guys were talking about the Disney movies doing like the R-rated thing, I was wondering if you thought that Warner Brothers would want a piece of that too, and maybe if James Gunn's take on the Suicide Squad could be
rated R.
R-rated, because I like the Guardians movies, but also it kind of feels like
that James Gunn's like hands were tied a little bit.
Right.
And so I would like to see him go back to something like Super.
Right, right, right. Yeah, it's a good call.
Slither.
So the question on the table.
Himself, so.
All right, well, thank you for the call. I guess the question on the table is...
Take it easy with those night terrors. Good luck.
Yeah, could James Gunn do a...
I thought we were going to make Brett guess it.
No. Could James Gunn do a rated R Suicide Squad, and would it fit? It could fit. And, yes. And because if you look at what James Gunn has done, like he mentioned with Super, and he certainly could do it, and it would fit.
And Suicide Squad as characters certainly would fit an R rating.
And you don't need it to lock into anything inside of the DCEU. The reason why the other one was PG-13 is they're trying to connect everything together.
Especially now if we're changing characters out, yeah, where we don't have Margot Robbie and we don't have Will Smith.
Right. What's the Joker? Is the Joker PG-13?
No, the Joker is R-rated, I believe.
I mean,
it's R-rated. With Joaquin.
Listen,
I believe.
If the Joker is rated R...
I don't know if that's confirmed yet, but I believe that's what's happening.
I think they're talking about it. I don't think it's been confirmed either.
Yeah, I don't know. The answer to the question is it could work, but I would not be surprised if they don't go that way yet. I don't know if they're ready for it. So, I'm not sure. What do you guys think?
I would love to see it because I think that's what the Suicide Squad, that first movie, should have been. Yeah. It should have been an R-rated jaunt with all those villains, especially Harley Quinn. Yeah, it was. You're right. I think that if James Gunn takes it. Did you ever see that movie, The Belko Experiment? Did you ever see The Belko Experiment?
No, I've never even heard of that.
Yeah, it's James Gunn. It's really good. It's James Gunn's brother or James Gunn?
James Gunn.
He wrote it.
He wrote it. Yeah. Okay. And it's dark. It's awesome. It's a weird jaunt through something, but has a huge ensemble cast like a Suicide Squad would. And if you got the R-rated go-ahead on that, there's so much more you could do with it. There's so much more violence. There's so much more villainy that could come out of that. That's I would sign on for a R-rated Suicide Squad.
Well, they're saying that Birds of Prey will be R-rated.
Okay, so it's possible.
We have the precedent set. Yeah. We could then move in. And Harley Quinn's in this, so you then transfer. Roxy, do you think she's going to be in Suicide Squad?
I don't think that Harley Quinn's going to be in Suicide Squad. Really?
See, I think we talked about this on Movie Talk.
At least
bring Will Smith and Harley Quinn back, and you have the continuity.
They might bring Will Smith back. They might not, but I don't think that they're going to bring Harley back.
Really?
I think the problem with making it R-rated, although I would prefer it, I think, because they would have more room to play, is that Suicide Squad did unbelievably well. Mm-hmm. And it would not have done as well, probably, if it had an R rating. So if you're hedging your bets here, if you're the studio, and you're thinking, okay, do we want to go this route? Now, with Birds of Prey, Harley's character is very, very R rated. And so is just the concept of the Birds of Prey, all of them.
Interesting. Yeah, I don't know. They could go either way. They could go either way. And I'd be okay with it. But
I think they're going to do a whole new cast.
For Suicide Squad.
Yeah, I think they're going to do a whole new cast.
They're calling it a soft reboot.
Yeah.
Wow. And it's called The Suicide Squad.
All right. Well, who knows? Who knows how it's going to
Maybe
turn
Amanda
out.
Waller will stay the same.
Yeah.
Possible. All right.
She got away with
what's
murder.
Next? Let's do one more. Let's do one more tweet, and then we'll do one more call, and we'll call it a day.
Okay. David Wilson, this is a great call. I don't know if you guys are familiar with this, but they could make the R-rated Marvel films and call it Marvel Knights because there was this comic run where Daredevil – Punisher, it was like more R-rated fare, and I think that would actually work perfectly. What do you guys think?
You got all the rights back to him sooner or
later.
You
get the rights back.
The KN or just N?
KN.
KN. So it's like Marvel Knights, but it's a different branding, so you know you're getting a different Marvel movie, and maybe, but I don't know if that will work inside the MCU.
I'll tell you why I don't think they should do that is because you're just limiting it to just Marvel movies, and you're going to have these Fox properties that move on to everything. So again, bringing back the reference like Miramax, right? It's like create a brand that is more the adult version, and you'll see the rated R movies, and I don't know, like whatever it might be. Let's say it's Fox, you know? Yeah. So Fox are going to be the ones that put out the Logans and the Predator movies and all this stuff, and it'll be Marvel Knights. Maybe you could just do it as like a side brand.
I like the Marvel Knights idea. I want to see more of like the Punisher and Daredevil together on things because we didn't get enough of that in Daredevil season 2. All we got was 5 episodes. Punisher season 1 was good. Punisher season 2, I'm slogging through.
I heard a
stage. I haven't even started it.
It is tough, man. It is not great.
What happened? They just bailed on it, you think? Because they knew it was going to go away?
We're in this double villain thing again. It's every time they do one of these shows, it's the first season, there's one villain. and it's awesome. And then the second season, it's like, let's throw three villains in. It's the same thing that Spider-Man had in Spider-Man 2 and 3. Right. It's just like all these villains, and we don't know where the storyline goes. Like, fight the villain, be done, and that's that.
It's right. also hard for people to be invested in it when they know.
No, it's going
to
get canceled.
Yeah.
How was Daredevil season 3?
I didn't watch it. Oh. I straight up did not.
Yeah. On purpose?
I can't believe I did. I watched all of those shows. It came out, and I was like, this show's going away. They're all going away.
So you don't want to get invested in it.
Why? Right. What am I going to do spending 13 hours of my life?
Yeah. All right.
It's the thing
with
Daredevil season 3 I watched, and again, like most of these shows, they're better served as 8 to 10 episodes because 13, they're just it's a ton of filler.
Was it good?
A lot of froggy episodes?
Yes. Yeah. And a lot of froggy storylines. Like, oh, great, he's a lawyer. Like, just give me more Daredevil.
Was it the worst season of Daredevil for sure?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, I mean, wasn't the worst.
I heard it was decent, but just not.
It's not
but
1 and 2.
I just don't want to watch a decent season of television.
Right. Look, you're not wrong.
It's like
saying.
Legion. I mean, everybody that likes Legion is, I think, is joking with themselves.
I
saying
loved
that,
Legion this
Josh.
Past.
Cody?
Josh, I love Legion. You watch yourself.
Okay.
The last episode was brutal, Cody. The last episode was one of the worst episodes of TV. Ugh.
Of season 2?
Yes.
I haven't finished season 2 yet.
No. Oh, my God. I loved that show. It totally lost me, though. Yes. But it got picked
Riley,
up hold on. For
Riley's got something
season.
For us.
Breaking
right?
news.
Yeah.
Paramount has scrapped World War Z 2 with David Fincher.
Oh, that's terrible news. No.
That was a Jeopardy question
so
last night,
So big news
too.
Coming out here that...
It's per the playlist. Paramount made the decision last night not to move forward with World War Z 2, despite the fact that the production had already been making plans to shoot in 5 different countries. Budget is apparently to blame. The playlist says Fincher's figure was below the first movie's $190 million budget. So they were going lower. The source is closer.
They
to production.
Wanted to hit lower.
Yeah, tell Collider that Fincher's budget was actually over that number.
Oh, wow.
Same source, and this is Collider sourcing. Same source tells us that Fincher's refusal to budge led Paramount halting pre-production, and Fincher is now off the project.
Listen, we know that Fincher has an idea in his head of what he wants to do, a movie he wants to do. Obviously, that happened we remember those emails from Sony when he was going to do Steve Jobs.
Right.
Here's why I'm kind of on the side of Paramount on this one.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you why. 200 plus mil, not including marketing, for this movie of a movie, the first movie that did good.
No, mm-hmm. You're saying he wants to come in under that.
No. He wants to go over.
Yeah, but sources were saying then that it was over.
See, Collider.
The figure was below the first movie.
Keep reading. Production tells Collider that Fincher's budget was actually over that number. And so that means like the 210, 215 or something. And then plus marketing. Yeah, I get it. I'm bummed. I would have loved to have seen Fincher's version of World War Z with Brad Pitt. Hmm. But I got to tell you that Paramount right now, they don't have the luxury of putting that kind
right.
of money.
And that's iffy too because it's a zombie movie, it's a genre movie, it has Brad Pitt, it has Fincher, these are all great names, but it doesn't mean box office. This doesn't have a Marvel
Universal
to it.
Was doing the monster one, right? Not Paramount.
Yeah.
Universal.
But
Paramount has Transformers and Mission Impossible right now.
And
but
they're building. I got to tell you, I think that as much as I wanted to see it, I understand it.
That's a big number, man.
That's a big number.
For a zombie movie.
Yeah. And off of a movie that did good.
Yeah.
It did very good, and it was supposed to not do good because of all the problems that it had.
Right.
But then when you landed Fincher, you're like, yes. But then when you hit, it's going to cost $210 million or whatever.
This has been going on, too, good. For years.
Yeah. So I get it.
Yeah.
All right. Cody, let's take a phone call and get the hell out of here. We got somebody? Yeah. Okay. All right. Hey, you're in Collider Live. Who do we got?
Did somebody say Destiny?
No, nice. It's Fake Ken. Hello, Fake Ken. How you doing?
Oh, boy. Dealing with, not dying over the weekend with Macuga and Ellis in Arizona.
Yeah.
Having to get ready for the next corruption event and getting ready for Jedi Council tomorrow because apparently now you guys are having to do that. Not live.
Right. Sorry
Best
about that,
decision
Ken.
Decision ever. Thank
sorry.
You.
I'm sorry, Ken. All right. So I don't know. You guys have like the magic number to kill through. I get phone calls from or DMs from people all the time and tweets from people saying they try so hard. But it looks like Fake Ken and C-Dub have found the portal.
You think they've got like 15 phones going on?
I don't know how they do
Nico
it.
Nico Rivoli,
it.
Too.
And Nico, it's Nico, Fake Ken, and C-Dub are like the three musketeers of the Collider Live phone calls.
You think we should start the V-word chant again?
No, I just don't know how they get in.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Yeah, it's
that's
like
that's what he said.
Yeah, it's I just feel you shall not pass. all right, what do you got, Fake Ken? What kind of question today?
Well, no, I just need a little refresher. Who's the third panelist for tomorrow's council?
I don't remember. I don't watch that show.
Danny Amendola.
Ash, because I had a new pork recipe I wanted to bring in, but well, what are you gonna do?
All right, cool. Is that all you got for us today, Ken?
That's all I got.
All right, thank you, Ken.
Pork recipe. Eat the pork.
Fake Ken's stew. Impression.
It's getting better.
About a six.
It was stronger at the top. He was losing it, and he needs to figure out how to speak with words like Ken, not just sound like Ken.
And he's got to work on his material. There's nothing worse than a really good impression with bad material.
With bad material. He's working on it. Yeah. I think he just opens up with big. All right, listen, so we're going to close big and say thank you guys very much for tuning in to Collider Live. We'll see you on
We'll see you tomorrow.
Collider Live. Peace out, Mother Fs.
Hey, Alex.